situation on Trinity, which, to remind you, is basically that Popular Stability is the leading party. They have the presidency equivalent, it's the chancellorship technically, as well as control of the Senate, and they are have been accused of political corruption, basically, because they're tied to the largest corporation in Trinity space, the Ikashi Arai Group, which basically controls merchant shipping and is also a research laboratory. And there's controversy about that, especially given that the current vice chancellor is the daughter of the head of Ikashi Arai. So there you go. The other situation, basically, you found out that Card, he met with the prince, and the prince more or less is supportive of Popular Stability, and has also revealed he was searching for, he was searching for the location, the result of the map. And you like his lyrics? They're good.
What are they? What is she saying?
The place is a lofty lord. Something, something. These lyrics make no sense, but you don't really notice it when you're playing the VN at all. You just have to pay attention, and then you're like, holy shit, what the hell was she actually saying? Yeah, you guys are now just kind of like on the planet. Or rather, Matt and Card and Demon, the humans, are on the planet. And I don't know if you want to bring Redhead.
We need
with
to
you.
Bring Redhead. Absolutely.
Or Burka.
No, no, that'll defeat the whole purpose.
I'm a buff motherfucker.
Yeah, he just... Redhead just did a lot of weightlifting. And then, you know, spray painted himself green.
Right.
Yes. So he's with us.
Well, I mean, right now it's up to you guys to decide what you're gonna do at this point.
Well... Do we know where anything is?
I want to go see the princess.
Okay, well, to answer your question, Card, you know where the Imperial Palace complex is. You're in it. It's in the city of Trinity. I mean, what specifically are you asking the location of?
Maybe... Well, is the, where are the representative, the bicameral buildings?
The congressional building?
Yes.
Yeah, it's like, it's not very far from the Imperial Palace. It's on the planet, in the same city. And yeah, you would be able to navigate to it if you wanted to go there.
I'd like to go there.
Okay. And Matt, do you still want to go talk to the princess?
Matt, don't know.
Okay. You find her in the palace. She's like walking through one of the gardens.
I want to go find a tailor.
Yeah, there's plenty of shops. Go ahead and roll to see what quality of tailor you find, though.
I'm going to bring Redhead along with me to the congressional building.
Okay, so if you bring Redhead out of the lander and, you know, in sight of anyone in the Imperial Palace, are you going to do that?
Well, I think first I'm going to have to make a disguise roll.
Are you going to try and disguise Redhead as a human being?
Absolutely.
You're going to put a fucking lampshade on him.
Well, that is up to Redhead for a disguise. I mean, I forget exactly what stat it's based on. I think it's Fellowship.
Fellowship. Well, are you sure, like, I can't do it for Redhead?
You might be able to give him a little bit of a buff, but he's... This is going to be an extremely difficult test, and I don't think his fellowship is very high to begin with.
Redhead.
26.
YOLO. Yeah. Just do it. It can't hurt.
There you go.
Maybe if I roll a 1.
Yeah, no. It's... As soon as anyone sees Redhead, they're, like, just aghast. Like, holy shit, what is this? This monstrosity, this gigantic green beast with, like, huge tusks and, like, you know, very poorly fitted armor. And, I don't know, he was on the lander, so I assume he just, like, walked out or whatever.
Can't he just, like, wear a big black robe?
I mean, if you want to completely encase him in, like, armor that blocks any of his skin, that might...
I don't really think a robe is armor, just clothes.
I mean, anything that would obscure his whole body.
That's still pretty fishy as fuck. I mean,
yeah, I mean, he is gonna look like an absolutely massive thing. But they wouldn't know immediately that he was an alien if he was wearing, like, a burqa.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so that's what you're gonna do?
Freak people out.
Fucking giant cloak, baklava, the
yes.
Fucking set of goggles.
Yes.
Alright. Sure. So you're burqa'd out, Redhead. And people are gonna give you strange looks, but they won't, you know, figure out that you're an alien just from that. Just from your size.
Allahu Akbar.
Yeah.
I should have looked for bombs to strap to my chest.
Yeah, truly. You had one strapped around your neck for a while.
I know, you fuckers.
But it wasn't a working one anyway, so.
Fuck you.
Demon, you can roll to see what your tailor is like.
I am back. Sorry about that. Did I miss anything?
I mean... Yeah, you found the princess.
I am.
And didn't say
anything. 46 was that roll, Kelly.
Oh, it was? Okay.
Oh, well, now I'll say something.
Go ahead.
Oh, well, I want to ask her about how involved she wants to be in us alleviating the political corruption.
I'm afraid I don't know very much about politics. I can't help you with this very much.
Wow, yeah, that was pretty fucking worthless, Matt.
Don't you shut up, card. I'm flirting.
No, I was gonna ask you who is the most important person that we have to kill. Would you say? Like
we'll
the house opposition.
This is a short conversation. Just let me finish it. Okay, so sure. I want. Fuck, you made me lose my train of thought. God damn it, card.
So you're done.
But yesterday you mentioned that you felt like the people should. Really control their own fate. Don't you feel like you have a civic duty to the people to help them?
Fuck, that's gay.
I think that there are good people out there trying to do how they know best to achieve that very goal, and I'm gonna do what I know how to do, but I just am not very good at the whole political scene.
What do you know how to do?
She just blushes at that.
Yes! I don't even have to roll a charm, and I already got her,
Oh, dear. You really are going places. Okay.
All right, well, at this point, I'm going to be like, so can I... I understand that politics isn't really your strong suit, but, no. I would like to think that I could call on you if I need some assistance in this new and unfamiliar culture. I want to put my hand on her shoulder again, because that's always my strong closer here.
Are you doing it again in a sexual way?
I mean, about as sexual as last time.
Okay, well, you can roll a charm.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah.
All right, well, first off, there's a couple factors here.
She vomits.
Plus, I get I can roll to a 95 and succeed on a charm.
She wonders really? Why this creepy little black.
Yeah, because
kid is
I have a plus 20
what
to
did
charm.
He roll?
I have 60 fellowship and I have pure nobility. So actually, I get a 90. So it technically succeeds.
Yeah, uh huh. I mean, so...
If this was an ordinary test.
It wasn't supposed to be, like, a really, like, big move. It was just a conversational closer.
Sure, she doesn't, like, really react to it, positively or negatively. Just ignores it.
Well, I mean, she was supposed to answer the question, too.
What was the question?
If I could count on her for assistance. If I need it. Alright, well, that was all I was going to get out of her. All right. So, we can... Alright, now me and Card, we gotta make a plan.
Yeah, well, Demon, you can go to the tailor. What do you want to get there? Are you looking for fancy clothes or something?
Well, the fucking animal skins I took last season. Do you remember the values on those?
I mean, they don't have, like, you know, profit factor value, if that's true.
I mean, but, like, the fucking lizard skin and the deer pelt, didn't they have, like,
they
something?
They do have AP values. I don't remember exactly what they were. I told you them.
I didn't write that shit down.
All right, Matt, so here's what I'm thinking. Because the terrorists are so... They're such an important talking point. We can just, like, either play off the various parties by doing that, or we could just fucking, like, walk into people's offices, I don't know, kill people and leave traces of the terrorists there. But I don't know what markings.
I'm all for false flagging.
I mean, I say that's what I was always going to do, is I say we try to, like, draw it up like there's some sort of connection between the terrorist party and Justice and Unity, and then we heroically put an end to their terrorist activities by blowing them both up. One foul swoop, I think.
Hold on there, let's not be too hasty.
Let's be extremely hasty. The sooner the Imperials are back on the throne, the sooner I can impregnate the princess, the sooner I can kill the princess, and my child will be the heir, and the sooner I can smother my child in the crib, then I can be the emperor.
I have no idea what's happening politically on this planet. I did not watch that shit at all.
That's so what the throne shit.
What do you need to know? I guess, because Card's a Jew, he did not upload the part where I explained all of these things, but... I'll summarize it. If you look in your handouts, you can see the list of all the major political parties.
Oh, there's handouts.
Yeah. The current ruling party is Popular Stability. They have a platform...
I think we should meet with the leader of Popular Stability.
Okay. They have a platform, basically, of supporting the status quo, and they're kind of, like, conservative and business-oriented and elitist. And they support the crown. They do not support devolved powers towards the East.
I want to meet with the leader of Popular Stability. I want to bring Card with me.
Okay, well, we'll get to that. I'm going to explain this to everyone, because they didn't fucking stay, and I told Card to upload it, but he didn't. Freedom and Development is the party that was responsible for turning this monarchy into a constitutional monarchy.
Oh, no.
They're quite popular. They have basically a platform of increased autonomy for the planets. They don't really want the crown to play a political role, but they don't want to abolish it. They are currently in power in the house. However, they have lost most of the seats in the Senate to Justice and Unity, and they are, you know, they're very populist, kind of, in terms of the arrangement of their policies. They're also fairly liberal. Justice and Unity is the newest party. It is nationalist, it is militarist, it's also Republican. They favor abolishing the crown entirely.
Sig Heil.
They control the minority. They lead the minority opposition in the Senate right now, but they don't have a control of either house. Most of their supporters come from the planet of Miral, and the reason they were able to gain a lot of seats in the last election is because they took them from Freedom and Development, because of terrorism, and they had campaigned against terrorists. Well, basically, they said that devolved powers promoted more terrorist movements, and it was kind of like appeasement to do that. So that was popular, and they ended up taking a lot of the seats in the Senate. They're very close to achieving a majority there. And were it not for popular stability very narrowly winning at the last minute, then they would actually control the Senate right now. The royal family exists right now. They have basically the current emperor has decided to more or less like devolve powers from himself to parliament and to individual planets. He pretty much supports the actions of freedom and development, but he doesn't really like to get too involved in politics. The Akashi Arai Group is a corporate conglomerate. They originally were two separate entities. The Arai Group was the in charge of interstellar shipping, and it merged with Akashi Laboratories about 15 years ago to create the Akashi Arai Group. They're the largest group economic power in the empire, and they have supported popular stability candidates financially. I think that's most... Also, yeah, there's terrorists.
What does the corporation produce?
What?
What does the corporation produce? Everything, or...?
They have very diversified assets, but their primary investment is in controlling interplanetary shipping, as well as communications, and also the research that the Akashi Laboratories does is primarily to improve the gravitic drive, make it more long-distance capable.
What exactly was the summary for popular stability?
Popular stability is the ruling party. They are conservative, they're traditionalists, they are elitists, they are business-oriented, and they are supported by Akashi Arai.
And they're for the crown.
They support the status quo. They think the crown should exist. They don't want it to just take over the government, though.
I noticed there's no faction that wants to do that.
That's us.
Well, there's no political party that has...
That's us!
I figured that's what we'd be here to do.
What's the name of the...
loyal imperial citizens.
Well, I guess we'll... I hope... when we walk in the congressional building, there'll be a big argument. And there we'll learn all about the terrorists.
I want to go meet the leader.
Fuck off!
I want... But this is essential.
They're probably in the congressional building.
Let's go to the congressional building.
Okay, well, alright, so, is everyone going to go to the congressional building?
Should we bring someone with us to make introductions?
Hopefully, Surf and...
I guess I'll put the Taylor thing on hold until you figure that out.
I thought everyone was
coming.
I'm
looking up the stats on it now. But...
Fucking Surf and Demon. Yeah, I can't hear
you. I heard Surf whispering there for a moment.
Can you barely hear me?
Now it's fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm coming with you guys.
For now, I guess I'm going to.
Okay, dokie. Redhead, too. With his super burka.
Oh, God. Swag. Alright. So, basically, you walk through the streets of Serenity. It's pretty modern. A lot of the architecture is kind of like more classical, but the actual city is... very technologically advanced compared to a lot of the Imperium, for instance. Cars are driving, you can see air traffic above.
Implying this sounds like Exterminata City to me.
The actual congressional headquarters itself is a very large building that is only like two blocks away from the Imperial Palace. And it's flanked on all sides by various executive offices and things. The grounds, there's a lot of people walking around. Most of them are in kind of formal attire. You notice that nobody here is older than like 35. And what's that?
Do they have red jewels on their hands?
No. Or no red jewels.
So basically, boomers aren't allowed to be in government here.
Well, it, also, this is something that was explained by the, what is effectively the steward of the realm to Matt and Card. In the Trinity's government, it's pretty, it's just generally like a kind of like a social norm that men join the military and women go into politics.
Oh,
and,
no.
Yeah. Also, you just haven't encountered anybody who's old at all yet, other than the Emperor.
There's also tech priests and all those kind of societies, right?
No, there's no tech priests in this, in the Empire at all. They just don't have tech priests.
Hallelujah.
One of the worlds in the Empire, Haster, which, it, on this map, it basically, Haster is a planet that's in the Tylus system. Whoops, I just backed out there. But Haster was a forge world in the past. It's not anymore. There are no tech priests.
Truly okay. A paradise on Earth.
So you make your way towards the entrance of the congressional building, and you're stopped by security, and they are asking to pat you down.
I'll allow it.
Literally have a heavy stubber on my back.
Oh yeah, weapons are totally banned on the planet right now. Like, for you guys, you're not supposed to have any weapons.
I don't
we've
have
been,
any weapons,
we've all been disarmed, so.
So
yeah, just submit to the pat-down.
Well, you and I have, at least.
Yeah. So, are you any of your other people trying to conceal weapons on your person?
I guess not.
I don't exactly think I could conceal a giant fucking chopper, so.
Okay. Yeah, sure. What's that, sir?
No, I'm not going to try concealing anything.
I want to bust out my Drox whip in the middle of Congress.
Yeah. Yeah, then they pat you down without incident. You are allowed to pass through. And you enter into a hallway with a receptionist and lots of people walking around.
I want to see the leader of the Popular Front or whatever the hell, Popular Stability.
I'll go to the receptionist and ask, where is the big room? You know what I'm saying.
I'm afraid not, sir. Please explain.
Where are the hearings held?
Why don't you go get me, one pepperoni?
So she looks confused by you, Card, but she turns to Matt and says, well, the Senate chamber is down that hallway over there, and she points to the left.
Are they currently in session?
They're not currently in session. There might be some senators around, though.
Could you direct me to the offices of the leader of Popular Stability?
The Chancellor? Yeah, her offices are not here.
Where are those at?
Well, okay, so she gives you the directions to the building. Their version of the White House. It's, you know, it's different. It's at a different location than this city block, essentially. It's some distance away.
Can she give us the locations of all the party's headquarters?
I mean, yeah. The party headquarters themselves, some of them are not on this planet.
Oh, well.
For instance,
shit.
Like, Popular Stability's headquarters.
Well, where the lead representative for said party would reside on this planet.
Okay, well, the party leaders are, right now, the leader of Justice and Stability is,
No, I know who they are, just where they're located at.
Right, so the leader of Popular Stability is the president, effectively, so she's there. The leader of Popular Stability is the Senate Minority Leader, so she might be in the Senate chamber. She has an office in the building, but, the receptionist wouldn't be able to tell you her location. And the leader of Freedom and Development is the House Majority Leader. So presumably she's also in the building, but she doesn't know exactly where.
I'll go on the Senate floor then.
Do I have the hawk with me?
I mean, you can bring it with you, sure.
Yes.
I guess I'll follow card onto the Senate floor, but I'm gonna go run and eat real quick, so I'll be back.
Act
so,
as card's bodyguard.
Okay. So are all of you going to the Senate chamber then?
I have to card's body, so.
Yes. Is it like house around the Senate, and then in the middle is where the actual senators are, or?
What?
How's the layout of the Senate room?
Basically, the Senate layout is just a speaking chamber. There's like a lectern at the bottom. Lots of chairs arranged around it. There's a back wall with which to present, you know, 3D holographic PowerPoints. Yes.
Yeah. Just like common one, like okay.
Yeah. I mean, so the Senate in Trinity is only 14 members. It's not a very big room.
Are they all aristocrats?
They're all very powerful people.
But are they, like, are common people?
I mean, there's no, like, the aristocracy never has existed, really. The monarchy was centralized before the Republic, so...
Oh, I see. So this would count as a formal setting.
Yes, definitely. Oh,
I have a minus 10 to all interactions.
Okay.
I'm being a fucking
insane person.
Paranoid survival death world, man.
Yeah.
Can I recognize any of the party leaders about?
So just on the Senate floor right now.
Or anyone important?
Let me check. I mean, in the Senate chamber itself, you can see the Senate Majority Leader talking with a couple of other people right now. If for reference, that is Kaori Mizuhashi. She's a member of Popular Stability.
I see.
Good guy.
So there's no like speech going on right now.
No, it's not in session. People are
okay.
Just. You know,
Well, I guess I'll go up to her, introduce myself,
alright,
and say, Mrs. Mizuhashi, I heard that there is a large terrorism problem in your system. Go on.
I don't know if it's really a large terrorist problem. Certainly we've been, hit with a string of bombings, horrible villains targeting the member of Popular Stability in particular. But this rash of recent activity is just, it's backbiting for our ascension to power. That's all. It'll pass.
She's politicking you, sir.
Yes, of course. Who is Popular Stability's, like, main rival? This is kind of an out-of-character question.
So, historically, Freedom and Development, that's... Freedom and Development's, like, the... originally the more popular of the two, and only recently Popular Stability has actually gained advantage over them. However, in the Senate, their main rival is Justice and Unity.
Yeah. Okay.
And that party does have royalists inside of it, as in royal family members backing it, from what I've noticed.
Does it?
Justice and Unity, they got a princess backing them.
Do they?
Bitches, are these?
Do they?
They do.
Which one?
You guys haven't talked to her yet, but they do have one. It's the other girl.
I see. Gernhild.
Yeah, Gernhild.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is correct?
I can't hear you, sir. What'd you say?
These people aren't religious, are they?
I mean, there are religions on the planet, but there's not...
This is the Imperium, fool.
They are not... they do not worship the Emperor in Trinity.
What the fuck?
Most of them just... Like, the only people who even know of the Imperium's existence are basically the embassy who have had to deal with rogue traders in the past. They're really far away from the actual Imperium.
Thank God.
They're all gonna die. This is a doom system card. I don't even know why we're wasting our time.
Because they have lots of money. So, yeah.
Money.
I did say money, so, yeah. Anyway, is there no one else about? Kelly?
What do you mean?
Is there no one else, important about?
You don't see any other, like, party leaders.
Well, I mean... Okay, well, sure.
Yeah.
What about Ryoko?
Ryoko usually is in the Imperial Palace. She's like the steward. Technically, she's a member of the executive branch, but she's not party affiliated.
I'm back.
Yeah, can this woman tell us about the terrorist group?
The, you're talking about Kaori Mizuhashi? The Senate?
Yes.
Majority leader?
Yeah.
I mean, she basically just told you about it. I mean, you'd have to ask more specific
questions. I mean, like...
Details.
Is there any known? Is there any known information about them, like where they're located at, or where their strongest supporters are?
So, yeah, I mean, if you ask her that, she's like, "Well, obviously they're located on Miral. They're titled the Miralan People's Army. So, you know, basically they're upset about a number of things, but they especially believe that popular stability has betrayed Miral.
Okay, so unity and justice is literally terrorist, then. Confirmed. Doesn't even sound very hard to set up.
Okay, well, thank you for that.
Rubs hand as we leave the office.
Senate floor right now.
Is her office in this building? Rather, I don't remember which peoples you said have offices in this building.
Basically any member of Congress does.
Okay.
So senators plus, you know, House of Representatives members.
And at this time they would be there? Or are they like out at lunch?
I mean, neither house is in session, so they could be anywhere. They have offices in the building, though.
Fuck it. I guess, you know, couldn't hurt to just break into one of them.
Yeah, it could. I want to,
Well, I mean, not now.
I think we need to speak with the leader of the party for stability. Whatever.
We just
popular stability.
Okay, that is the Chancellor, aka the President. They live in their version of the White House.
We need to go there.
Oh.
First, okay. Though, I think we should stop by the Royal Palace, and we need to get, like, some paperwork documenting it's, like, okay for us to go visit. So we can avoid the whole security.
Do we actually need that, though?
Do we, Callie?
Just kick in the
or
door.
Or can it just be assumed?
Yeah, you can... I'll just assume that if you go back and get the paperwork, sure.
Okay, can we go to the White House, then?
Yeah.
Well, do you guys want to go or you want to stay here?
I'm sworn to carry cards burdens.
I don't... Why are you going there?
Because, well, I'm going to start plotting.
Okay,
it's really
so...
It's obvious what we need to do here. It's basically just, like, supplant these
people
okay. And install Imperial rule and gain lots of favor with the Empire.
Yeah, okay, Demon.
You know, take over this whole vast little empire for our own.
Name it Charlie.
What a
name
new,
it Charlie.
A new series of ideas. Never been thought before. Thank you, Demon.
Yeah.
I say we go get the orc ship, we fucking get a log going, and we fucking invade the planet.
That ship's probably gone.
They probably blew that shit up.
On accident. Anyway, Matt, why are you actually going there?
To start plotting.
What does that even mean?
As in, like, I'm going to start the downfall of one of the major parties.
Via?
Painting them as a terrorist organization.
How?
I mean, we could...
Are we gonna blow up the White House?
I'm gonna lie.
Just, like, frame unity and justice for assassinating someone important in freedom and development.
Yeah, well, we don't know where any of those people are, and they're probably in this building, not the White House.
We don't have to do it right now.
I need to talk.
We do need to do it right now.
Just shut up. I need to talk to the leader of popular stability, the president. I need to talk to her.
Those are the people we should pretend to be allied to. Popular stability.
That's what I agree with them.
So what are you doing?
So we're going to the White House.
Okay. Yeah, it's much farther from the actual Imperial Palace than Congress is. You can take a bus or you could walk there, but it would be like probably a 20-minute bus ride or about an hour of walking.
We have Vox comms, right, between each other?
Microbeats.
Do you,
Tom?
I mean, I have a microbeat. Matt, do you have one?
Microbeats have a range of like 1 kilometer.
Matt, do you have one?
So you have a microbead.
Do I have a what?
A microbead.
No.
Or some kind of communicator.
Voxcaster, is that what you're talking about?
Any Vox shit that you could use to communicate?
No.
Okay, well.
It's unlikely. I'm fairly certain that everybody starts with something like that.
I don't walk. I think Vox may be.
It's because they're orcs. That's not normal.
So you're all walking there?
No, I'll be staying at this building.
Okay.
Trying to find the leader. Or who was this woman? The House opposition leader, and maybe the minority leader.
Okay, I mean, you'd have to specify more, but for now, I'll go to the...
Kana Asumi.
Okay, that's the minority leader in the House. Sure. You can begin searching for her, but we'll move on to the White House. She's not actually called the White House. But yeah, Matt, you show up there. Who else is going?
Just Card.
Well, Card's not going.
Oh, he's not? Then just me.
Okay. You show up alone to the, the executive mansion. How about that? And the grounds are green and yeah, all that. There's a big iron gate with a little security booth next to it to gain entrance.
I want to flash them my papers.
Okay. Well, I mean, they're legitimate, so... you're allowed entrance into the building.
I just want to make a correction. I'm actually looking for Miyuki Sawashiro.
Okay, so you're looking for the leader of Justice and Unity.
Yes, yeah.
So,
is there, like, an Akisha Ari headquarters on this planet?
A what?
Akisha Ari group?
God, that is the most butchered pronunciation.
I don't know what you mean.
He's talking about the Akashi Ari headquarters, any
Akashi
building.
Arai. I mean, they have lots of offices all over the place, and there is a headquarters on this planet. It's not their main one, though. They're based out of Anedra. But they have plenty of offices around. Okay, so Matt, you come in, and basically there's another receptionist in the hall here.
Okay, so, sorry, yeah. So could you, direct me to the Chancellor's office?
She's like, do you have an appointment?
I don't, but I'm actually here on, orders from the royal family. I'm a new advisor, and they want me to run down and introduce myself. So I think this constitutes an important enough issue to let me in. And don't you think you could slide me in? At this point, I'm gonna like lean on the desk,
oh,
sort of like smile.
Fucking Jew.
She's just like, I see.
Can I roll a deceive now? Does that fail?
Yeah, you can try to make something up to tell her.
Okay, that passes. Wait, no. Well, it does. Barely.
Does it actually?
I think so. 60
plus.
There's
no negative modifiers.
Yeah, I mean, but what's your actual skill?
60. Oh, and that doesn't pass. Shit.
Yeah. She says, like, wait just a moment here. And she begins dialing to the,
calling
she starts calling a number. You don't know exactly what's going on.
Get out of there, Matt.
Matt just punched her in the face.
Okay, well, before we resolve that situation, we can go now to, Card, Demon, and Surf. We're at the congressional offices. And, basically, you just haven't been able to find Yuki anywhere here.
Damn it.
She doesn't even seem to be in the building.
Do we know where her office is?
Yes, you've been to her office. She's just not there.
Well, I'm still gonna go into it, unless it's locked.
It is locked.
Surf?
Lights are off.
Surf?
Are you gonna try and break into her office?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, just so you know, I mean, you can very clearly see there are, like, security cameras all over the building.
Oh.
I mean, this is like a...
Well,
like,
I mean, if you can clearly see them, and if there's, like, you know, more than one, then I'm not gonna bother.
Yeah, there are several.
Okay, sure.
They are set up specifically to prevent activity like this, so, I mean...
Is there a security office nearby?
There's definitely a security office somewhere in the building.
We're not gonna go that far yet, sir, so... So... But breaking into her office was fine. But, not security. Well, that's unfortunate. Looks like you'll be staying here, Surf.
Rip.
Is there a room next to it?
Just vox me once she shows up.
Basically, it's just you're in a hallway, and next to the hallway is the entrance to an office with her name on a big plate outside. There's a window, but the shutters are closed and, like, it's dark. So. There is a bench nearby.
Yeah, I point towards the bench and then wave goodbye. And I'm gonna go to the palace again, because I want to speak to the prince.
Okay, you can go there. Demon, are you doing anything?
Following card.
Okay. Meanwhile, back at the White House, not White House, the woman has dialed the phone number and has talked discreetly over it. And she hangs it up and smiles kind of blankly at you, Matt.
So at this point, I'm sweating a little bit, but I maintain my composure and be like, listen, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm not from around here. Do you want the truth? I'm actually a Seneschal for a rogue traitor. And I've been sent here on an explicit mission by the royal family to help alleviate corruption. Now, you might think I'm spinning you a nice long tale there, but that's the truth. And, you know, you seem like a smart lady with a good head on your shoulders. And if you can't believe that, I'd welcome you to call the Emperor to see just exactly why I should be visiting. And you know what? Do you really want to wait in a million call lines to talk to the assistant boot wiper of the Emperor? Or are you just going to let me in for 5 minutes? You know I'm unarmed. What's the worst that could happen?
Oh. Roll to rape.
Do I need to roll some for that?
You can go ahead and roll, just to this determines what I'm doing. Okay, well, I mean, she continues to smile nicely at you. And then down the hallway behind her, you can see a couple of people approaching you. One of them is very clearly the Chancellor herself, so... They're walking in your direction right now.
Beautiful. That's exactly what I wanted. At this point, I want to be
explosive.
I want to turn around. I want to.
Hello, Akbar.
I want to give like a slight smirk to the Chancellor as she approaches me. I want to like lean back against the desk and cross my arms.
Card.
You're leaning back the against the receptionist desk while you're sitting on it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, yeah, so...
I pull out a cigarette and light it as well. Okay, there's put no, it out.
There's no
put
smoking.
It out. Okay. I do it anyway. I'm a rule breaker, baby.
Oh, boy. So, eventually, the Chancellor comes closer, and you can see flanking her are the Vice Chancellor and some guy in like a suit with a sidearm, so presumably bodyguard. And she's like, "All right, you wanted a meeting. I know who you are. What do you want to talk about?"
Does she know who I am?
She says she does.
And who exactly do you think I am, ma'am?
Oh, can we please not waste time on these silly mind games? I really am quite busy, you know. 8 planets, 7 systems. A lot of work.
Well, if you want the truth, I think we should speak somewhere more private. You're more than welcome to bring your associates, but this isn't really a topic to be discussed in public. At the point, I want to kind of, like, throw a thumb back at the receptionist and snarl at her a little bit.
Okay, she just kind of like, you know, nods and motions for the Vice Chancellor and the bodyguard to kind of leave. And she leads you back towards another room, just a small conference room. Sits down and says, "All right, you got like 5 minutes. What do you need?"
"Ma'am, I came here today to tell you that I am part of an ongoing, not only just part of leading an ongoing investigation to investigate terrorist ties between the who's the Republican Party, Freedom and Development."
Republican? That's Justice and Unity.
Justice and Unity. What's the name of the terrorist organization?
The Morale and People's Army.
To investigate a terrorist connection between the Justice and Unity Party and the blah 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 people, blah blah blah, whatever they're called.
The fucking faggots.
And well, I guess I need to roll a deception on that.
Yeah, you definitely do.
Nailed it.
Well, that's certainly interesting. The Crown hasn't informed me of anything of the nature, and actually, it's usually my job to handle this sort of thing. Also, I must say that's quite an unusual theory. Do you actually have any evidence behind this? Have you found anything out?
Well, that's sort of why I'm here.
My buddy Strelick told me.
Strelick told me on the
You see,
the
Strelick, he's very good.
Now, the reason the Crown did not see fit to inform you is because, unfortunately, not only do you serve as this nation's chancellor, but you are also the political leader of an opposition party. And, you know, it would look a little bit shady if you started connecting the dots where they shouldn't be connected. So, understandably, in an effort to avoid the political muddying of hands, they kept you out of the loop. I wouldn't take any personal offense to it.
I don't think she's the opposition.
She is. She is.
She's the.
She's directly the opposes
right now, but she's not like an opposition right now. She's just. She's actually government at the moment. Their opposition.
She's like the president, dude. It'd be like if Obama was the opposition to the Obama administration.
It's like if you told Obama there was a terrorist connection between ISIS and the Republicans, he'd listen. Shut up.
That's what you're doing, basically. So, I mean, yeah. Again, she's like,
that isn't the case.
Well, okay, so you want evidence for this, but I can say right now, I myself, this is the first time I've heard of anything like this. I'm very interested to know more, but I can't tell you, I just simply don't have anything to assist in this investigation.
Well, I understand that, but I thought I should report a worrying rumor to you. Who's the people card met? Who's the girl card met? Is she with?
No. The senator? Or in the Senate?
The senator? What's her name?
All right, the person that Card just met this session, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Kaori Mizuhashi. She's the Senate Majority Leader. She's also a member of Popular Stability.
Yeah. I have recently, through one of my contacts, been informed that there's a possible plot to assassinate that name you just said. through, let's say, some rather shady sources. Now, you might ask what I'm basing this on. There's recently been sightings of a rather foreign species to this planet.
Oh boy.
Oh fuck.
And I'm assuming that he is part of the plot to assassinate your party member.
And the twist is he's talking about Surf.
If you could... Now, of course, I need you to keep this on the down low for now. But I think that I wanted to inform you in advance so you can be one step ahead of this information when it hits. And that once, if I am not able to stop this plot, which it's unlikely because the gears are already very much in motion and I have very little traction here on this planet, at least we can get out ahead of it from that point and, you know, be prepared to deal with it in whatever way you see fit as head of government. Do we need to roll deception on that?
Absolutely.
You sure I can't just roll a charm, like slap her on the ass after all of that?
I encourage you to do that.
She is completely taken aback. As soon as you said, like, there's an assassination plot against one of her party members, she's like,
yes.
Okay, this is a problem that you should definitely seek to resolve immediately. I need to take care of some things in light of this news, and if there's nothing else, I will be excusing myself, as you can tell. It's very busy, and especially this now on top of everything.
Now we assassinate someone entirely different.
Rest in peace, Redhead.
Now, before...
be killed by the Gestapo.
Before... Before I take my leave, I just ask for your discretion in this matter. I ask for 48 hours before you notify anybody else of this plot. And by that time, if I have not been able to crush it, I will let you know and you will be able to do what you see fit. But in the meantime, I think it's absolutely vital that no members of the political system here, or perhaps any outside members of the terrorist organization, are made aware of this until... we have the chance to sneak up on him and get him before they can get us. What do I need to roll on that?
That is also a deception, yeah.
I'm gonna fake point that.
Okay.
There we go.
Alright, she very hesitantly, she says, like, okay, 48 hours, no more, and there better not be anything happening, or we're gonna have a problem, you and I.
What does she mean by something happening?
Insofar as, well, that's what she says, but, I mean, you can surmise what you will out of it.
And at this point, I wanna bow deeply, kiss her hand, and take my leave.
Okay, well, she definitely... That gesture is very unusual to
her. Should I roll a charm?
You can do that.
Come on, 100. Slap his ass. Let's do it.
Flash a winning smile.
She just, like, turns her face away, like, oh my god. This is really
no. She wants it. They all do.
Right. Okay, so, yeah. She scurries out of the room.
So, plan. Do Justice and Unity party members wear, like, regalia or party uniforms, or because they're militarists, right?
They are militarists.
All right, we need to get some of those, dress up some guardsmen as, students.
I mean, okay. They don't fucking wear, like, I'm a party member uniforms everywhere they go. I mean, they wear generally more professional-looking, or, you know, more official-looking attire than a lot of the other members, and that's in non-formal settings. In formal settings, everyone pretty much wears, you know, the same sort of suits, basically. Yeah.
Well, regardless.
All right, so what the fuck are we going to do now? That was a terrible decision I made.
That was great. That was really good. We need to kill her and then blame the justice and whatever whore on it.
Instead of killing the person that he said was going to die,
well,
all attention is focused on that. We should assassinate the freedom and development chick.
Why?
That's actually not a bad idea.
Problems. Maybe Callie's going to kill them on their own time.
Alright, well, Redhead, you're gonna be the sacrificial lamb here, man. I'm sorry.
I already gave could probably make it through, like, bursting into an office with a machine gun and running shit down and running.
That's what I was saying.
Surf, do you have any device that'll allow you to deactivate the cameras? Did you buy Camera Loop?
Wait.
Did you ace Camera Loop?
How do I camera?
Like, do you have some device, or can one of your mechadendrites assist? Can you just fucking put a tarp over the camera?
I think they'd find that pretty suspicious.
I didn't mean literally, but...
If you can get me close to a generator, overpower the power...
Okay, so we're gonna blow up the power.
No, it's gonna short circuit.
What... Alright. I don't think that's that reliable, but... We just need...
Card, you guys are back at the Imperial Palace now.
Yeah, I'm gonna find the prince.
Okay. Yeah, he's just strolling around.
I won...
So, what are we gonna do?
I think the best idea is we have to make Justice and Unity, like, openly seen as the terrorist group. There's just no other way around it. And the only way to do that is to, like, kill off other party members? Not of their group, obviously, but of, like, popular stability. Maybe not kill, but maybe we can kidnap the leader of popular stability in the Senate, the one you just said is gonna die for whatever reason.
Oh, fucking stability.
We'll kidnap her and fuck up her office completely. And
alternative idea.
Leave traces of Justice and Unity.
Lower ranking member of popular stability to keep them off our backs while we plot the assassination of someone major. Because then I think just the fact I pitched the theory and then one of them mysteriously died, like, well, afterwards.
We could rob one of the tanks where they store all the money.
We could just find some, like, guy's political lackey, like, member of his staff and just, like, beat his ass in an alley or something while we're fast.
That's true, we could do that.
Like, fucking salute the Republic of Trinity afterwards and run off into the night.
Maybe,
okay, best idea, right here. Building on Demon's idea. Alright, so we're in the lady we're supposed to assassinate's office, right?
You're not now.
Well, they were.
Well, Surf is still there.
They were talking to her on the floor of the Senate. They've never been in her office.
Well, they need to go to her office.
Well, Surf's there.
Surf's waiting outside of Miyuki's office. She's the leader of Justice.
Yeah, well, I'm sure it's right next to it anyway.
Right, well, we need to go to her office, and we need to see her secretary.
I'm not beating up the secretary.
Shut up, Surf. You're not doing shit.
Shoot her in the head.
No. Surf, walk into the building and shoot her in the head. Scream Justice and Unity while you do it.
Maybe we could do that. Just get someone from the ship to just suicide bomb. We will ourselves become terrorists.
I mean, could the Eldar lady, the death cultists, like, blow someone's head up telepathically?
Because, I mean, this empire is, like, technically heretical, so we could totally get an empire cult or an empire
actually,
cultist.
Actually, you know... You know, Matt, that's actually a pretty good idea. Maybe we can use the Eldar woman's crazy psychic powers to assist us somehow. What can she actually do, Callie? I would assume after talking to her for over a month, I would know.
I mean, you don't know her list of powers.
Can she compel suicide?
I don't think I just have, like, a spreadsheet in my mind made, but.
Most of the Eldar Farseer powers are actually, like, divination related. They have, like, a couple of combat ones, but they're not really direct combat powers.
It's the armor shit.
Can she compel suicide, though?
I don't think so. I will go read to see more about it, but I don't believe they have that kind of psychic powers.
Well, then let's just do what my original plan was. Wait for the secretary to go home, jump her in an alleyway, carve 24 hours J and L into her stomach with a knife, and then leave her pinned up somewhere. And then, heroically, we're going to shoot somebody from the ship as they're walking towards. I'm going to run up behind them, shoot them in the head while they're walking towards, and we're going to put like a Justice and Unity badge on them, and I'm going to show the corpse to the Chancellor, and it's going to go beautifully.
Or we could do a bank trade where all the money of the populist funding groups go into, surprisingly, the Justice and Unity funding groups.
Shut up, Surf. That's a good idea. Kill yourself. Now, what we got to do is we gotta kill this secretary. Actually, we should probably do a Surf.
I feel like killing a secretary really won't help us out. We'll just...
I feel like it will stir people's pot. I feel like...
Does the secretary really matter?
I feel like she would notice if
she had
24...
That's the point, is that they don't matter, so they're not going to be missed, but it'll still cause a political outrage.
Are we really going to...
Probably not.
Just I mean, it will. Why don't we do it and see what happens? We have nothing to lose.
Okay, yeah. I like that idea better. Just do it and
just
see what happens.
Just to let you know, the only offensive psychic power that the Eldar has is the Eldritch Storm, which is like a lightning storm.
I know what it is.
Yeah. All the rest
We're not going to resort to that yet. That's like a fucking atomic bomb on our person.
That's when we'll blow up the whole Senate via for Vendetta style, place the Emperor in charge.
1812 Overture playing in the background.
Are we going to do the bank one, or is that not?
I think that would take too much time to figure out. Yeah, let's fuck the prince. I don't need to talk to him anymore. Okay. I just want walks.
Let's go. Send Surf into what's her face's. Let's all go to her office. The lady who's supposed to be assassinated.
Okay, it is
the woman we talked to, Kaon.
Yeah,
Kaori. I don't know what her name is.
Senator Mizuhashi.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Well, it's getting to be like 6 p.m. planet side. Basically, it's kind of like evening at this point.
Alright, well let's everyone post up in nondescript places. Don't be obviously like standing outside of the office, like the six of us, like strange looking people. It's like,
hey, I'm unremarkable, so no one's even gonna know.
Actually, perfect. Have Gamer walk in and check make sure there's a secretary there.
You know, maybe we should just have Demon do this on his own. If, like, the fucking security camera feed sees six people, one of them very large and green, walking through the hallway with knives, and then leaving with blood all over themselves.
We're waiting for her to leave the office, and then we're gonna do it while she's on her way home, and then we're gonna drop her corpse in front of the office.
Oh, how are we dropping in front of the office?
We're gonna have Demon put on a mask, run up, drop it, and then run away.
To get him put on the anonymous Legion mask.
I'm gonna fucking razor wire.
Hey, you know, it is fucking, it's up. November 5th today, so.
It is. Remember the 5th of November.
Yeah.
So, we're all posted up around the office at like 6 o'clock, right?
I am.
Yeah, who all is actually gonna go and stand outside the office?
I will.
Already
there. Maybe it should just be me and Demon.
Yeah, I don't want to get myself involved.
Alright, Matt.
Matt, actually, you probably shouldn't.
Actually, I'm the face, so that's a terrible idea.
Yeah.
Kelly, just a quick question. Are the cameras connected by network or by wire?
They are connected into the wire to the building itself.
I'm also I'm not going to be wearing, fucking armor and uniform. I'm going to be wearing, just a suit or something.
Okay, well, also, you guys don't have any weapons on you. I mean...
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Can I get some piano wire?
Come on.
You wanna get a fucking? You're gonna. Well, okay. Well, I mean.
Can he get like a small kitchen knife from our quarters?
He's still gonna have to disguise this on his person.
It's not hard to hide a small kitchen knife.
Well, I mean,
was chaos.
There are metal detectors and shit, so you won't be able to just like walk in with a knife.
All right, wait. Stash the small kitchen knife outside the building. Walk in, see the secretary is there. Wait for her to go home, and then you know, carve her up like a pumpkin.
Why don't you just go into her house and kill her? She probably has like knives in her house.
Yeah, I'm not gonna kill her. I'm gonna follow her home.
Yeah, just wait till she gets home, break in, and then rape. And, not that last bit.
Follow her home, then.
Okay, so I mean, everybody else, what are you doing? Well, Demon's gonna be posted up outside the office. It's like 6 p.m. right now.
I want to be back at the palace, and I want to be schmoozing with the princess to have a solid alibi.
Okay.
I will be with Matt.
Okay.
Before we do this. Guys, why don't we just pull the fire alarm and cause chaos? So much chaos that we can quickly kidnap her in the midst of it.
Because it's less descriptive, you know, you, like, just wait.
Yeah, but then you can't blame the town.
This is fine.
Damn it, Surf. Your high time preference is gonna get us killed.
Yeah. We'll assume everyone is just in the palace.
Okay, yeah, even Redhead, he's fucking... You guys are having, like, a little party.
Redhead's... No, we need to make a point to not be seen. Redhead needs to stay in the ship, because he's considered a terrorist suspect. Remember?
Yeah.
Okay.
Redhead's in the goddamn ship. He's in the brig. Under blankets.
I'm gonna start throwing my squig army.
And straw.
Okay, Redhead, you're tending to your patch of orcoid culture.
He's watering it.
You've managed to, like, produce enough fungus to feed yourself today. Alright, so, yeah, it's 6 p.m. It's, you know, the building's still open to the public and everything, and, you know, you're able to just walk in there and, you know, sit down. There's, like, a bench that's nearby to the office.
Can you chill on the bench?
Okay, yeah. How long are you going to wait there?
Until she goes home.
Pretty much, yeah, until I see...
What is she?
Well, we don't actually know what she looks like, do we?
I mean, she's the main secretary at the front desk.
You're gonna... Right. The receptionist of the fucking building? That's who you're gonna kidnap?
Looking for...
No, it was the, secretary for the...
I mean, okay, so you go into her office first, then, is what you're telling me. And see if she's there.
Yeah. Not the receptionist for the building, like, the actual, like, secretary for the...
Yeah, okay. Well, I mean, alright, so you go in there. The, office of, the Senate Majority Leader is pretty nice. The front area is basically a waiting room with a receptionist desk there. And you can see, she's just a young, probably, like, 18-year-old girl, working at the desk. And she smiles as you enter. She's like, how may I help you?
Oh.
Just say, like, I made a wrong turn.
Yeah. Wrong room, love.
Oh, so that's fine. That. Have a nice day. And,
you too, baby girl.
So, yeah, she just kind of, like, smiles and goes back to typing on her little hollow computer.
I'm going to pop my neck disturbingly as I walk out.
Okay. yeah, so basically you're gonna wait there for as long as it takes, and around like 8 o'clock you see the actual senator herself, Calvary. She comes to her office and she goes in about 45 minutes later. She comes out and you know, she's too busy to really pay attention to her surroundings. She doesn't really even notice that you're there. It's 9 o'clock now, and finally the lights in the office go out, and the door opens. The secretary begins walking towards the entrance of the building.
I'm gonna let her get some distance before I start catching up.
Okay. She's walking to the exit, and eventually she comes to like the security checkpoint at the entrance. She gets out her little card and scans it through the machine, and the security officers are like, "Have a good night," and she's like, "Yeah, you too," and she starts walking out of the building.
Following.
Okay. Security guards just kind of let you through. You have a guest pass, so you're able to get out. She starts walking towards the street. There's a very large and prominent bus stop right next to the congressional headquarters.
Okay. Awareness check. Who's around?
Okay, roll awareness.
Okay.
I don't know.
There's perception 39, awareness is drained.
Okay, yeah, basically right now it's just you two.
Has she noticed me?
No.
So?
She's sitting on the bench at the bus stop right now.
This is like a tiny little girl, right?
Yes, she's an 18-year-old woman.
You not see where she goes first?
She's gonna get on a bus.
Yeah, but can you not, like, go under the bus? I don't know what kind of quality.
Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna hide under the bus, like Splinter Cell.
Oh boy. go ahead.
Debating whether to do it right now or not.
No, don't. There's probably, like, cameras, and you just fucking walked outside.
Follow her home, dude.
Alright.
May not be going home, that's the thing.
No, like, stand a little further away from the bus stop. Wait for the bus to show up.
Alright, yeah. So, it actually takes quite a while for a bus to show up. You sit there until, like, 10:30. Meanwhile, back at the palace, everyone's getting hammered and having a good time. You're standing in the cold with a trench coat and fucking
well, I'm definitely
this little girl.
I'm definitely not drinking, because that's not okay.
Is the princess hammered? I think it's time to split this into two storylines here.
Oh, boy. No.
I'll light up a low stick.
Is she allowed to drink?
She's definitely not old enough to drink. She's like 14.
Dude, she's 15. It says in the sheet. You can't be dropping the age.
She's 15 years old, technically.
Am I drinking?
She recently had her 15th birthday. if you want to drink, yeah.
Who? What other women are drinking?
Lots of women at the court are drinking right now.
Who's the most powerful woman that's drinking?
Is Ryoko drinking? Official positions. No, Ryoko's not even there. She doesn't like parties. She's never in public.
Is the prince there?
The prince is there. He's got girls around him.
Can I go walk up and talk to him?
Sure.
So, I want to ask him who's the most impressive catch I could have here tonight.
Well, he doesn't really like you.
Why?
Your original encounter with him. Basically, you preferred his sister to go talk to her over him, and he hasn't really gotten over it. He's kind of, like, childish. He also doesn't like the fact that you're trying to encroach upon his territory, which is to have all of the women in the court.
Let me clarify then. Who's the best woman I could bag here that you're not interested in? I'm just going to, like, playfully punch him in the shoulder. Don't you roll a charm on that?
Yes.
All right. He's drunk. That should pass.
He just points over to the corner of the room. There's a very plain-looking girl in that corner of the room, drinking with, like, two of her friends who are much less attractive.
I feel like you're yanking my chain here.
That's what he does.
All right, well, we'll cut back to Demon, but okay. I want to spend the rest of the night schmoozing with the prince, like, trying to buddy up
you're
with
trying
him.
Trying to make him not hate you?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so back to Demon. Eventually a bus pulls up, and the girl gets her little bag and her purse, and gets onto the bus.
Alright, I'm gonna let her get onto it, and then I'm gonna start sprinting towards it. Like, I need to be somewhere in a hurry.
Okay, you sprint towards it.
Fucking catch that shit.
Oh, and you wanna get on?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you sprint towards it, and,
But I want to have, like, the collar on my jacket popped up, concealing my face.
God.
You are, the bus driver looks at you and he's like, what the fuck? But he doesn't, you know, pay very much mind to it. He's like on a, he's fucking had the night shift for a while. He knows these people. And yeah, on the bus, there's just two people, other than you and the girl, that is. And they're just sitting in opposite seats from each other.
Including she's seated.
She's seated.
Where?
Like in the middle of the bus. She's sitting.
Fuck. I'm gonna sit at like the front.
Okay.
I'm gonna back to her.
Alright. So the bus starts driving and it drives around, drops off the other two passengers. Seems like nobody's actually really out tonight at all. For whatever reason, I mean, you don't really know the local customs. It just seems like nobody is here tonight, except for, like, on the streets, that is, except for, like, you know, the people that you saw earlier, and now you two. And the bus eventually pulls into a kind of like a upper middle class area, and you can see, like, kind of apartment blocks running through it, and the girl gets up to get off.
Okay.
Should get up.
So she... I'm gonna let her get off.
No, don't do that!
Up, starts walking towards one of the buildings.
Fuck, demon, you fucked up hard there, dude.
And I'm gonna let the bus get, like, a little bit down the road before I stand up and, like, interrupt the bus driver, sort of force him to stop the bus.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. Basically, the actual buildings themselves, like, so there's a large lawn in front of these buildings, which, you know, is, like, meticulously maintained, and then the actual buildings themselves are large, kind of like brownstones. And she has been walking towards one of them that's kind of on the end of the block. She's still on the sidewalk right now.
Anybody out?
No, there's no one out.
How are you lost your puppy?
Looks like your dog ate it. Start
closing the distance up behind her.
Are you fucking sprinting at her, or...?
No.
Okay, well, I mean, yeah, you can walk fast and get pretty close to her. Eventually she does find the building, or she gets to the building that she lives in, and she starts walking down the lawn towards the entrance.
Now, is it like a house, or is it like an apartment block?
It's an apartment block. It's like a big brownstone.
Fuck. Yeah, rush her now. Take her.
Yeah, bunch of quick shanks.
Okay, so you're going to sprint towards her and do what exactly?
Well,
pick her up.
I mean, I could probably break her neck.
Why are we trying to kill them right away?
Snap her neck.
Yeah, I'm going to snap her neck.
That's what you're going to go for?
That's what I'm going to try to do. If not, I'm just going to fucking strangle her.
All right.
Gain 5 corruption points.
I'll go fuck. Strelick is insane.
Yeah, he is.
Okay, yeah, you roll for a charge. Get a little bit of bonuses because she's completely surprised. I don't know what your weapon skill is.
44.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you definitely have charged her. You're going to try and break her neck, you said?
Yeah.
Okay, that'd probably just be a strength test, I think. So,
wonderful. Fuck, I'm gonna fate point that.
Okay, well, this is gonna be an opposed strength test because, you know.
That's fine. I don't mind.
Keep that. Okay. Yeah. She's like, as soon as she hears you running towards you, or hears you running towards her, she kind of like turns around to see what it is. And before she can get fully turned around, you, like, have your hand around her neck and her head. And she's like, what? And she just, like, snap her neck immediately.
You go on.
Excellent.
And she just goes limp instantly.
Oh, God.
Check her purse for any sharp objects.
Check Demon her purse for, like, pen and paper. Girls
like Jack the Ripper.
No, check her purse for sharp objects. But she has a nail file in there or something.
I hope you were wearing gloves, Demon.
Of course. Classy black leather gloves.
Oh.
Fucking Agent 47. Yeah, check her purse. What she got? She got anything sharp?
She has, like, lipstick and bubblegum and a wallet. And, I mean, there's nothing, like, sharp in there, really. There's
Is there, like, a chrono with the faces of her cerebric palsy brother?
Burrow the pin into her flesh and tear 24 and then do J and L.
Okay. Right, for the Republic and for Miral.
For Miral as well as what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
And, like, I don't know, write horror on her face.
With the write J and L on her forehead with the pen.
Yeah, write that too. Basically, lots of, like, incriminating propaganda that links Miral's People's Army with justice and unity.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. Also, just so you know, like, right now,
also,
you're just
like,
on
what,
the 48 sidewalk.
Hours? That was a good idea.
he's not on the sidewalk.
He's like, so he's a little bit distant from the sidewalk.
You said they
she
were
walking
on the lawn.
From the lawn, or from the sidewalk to the lawn, but he got her almost as soon as she got off the sidewalk.
Well, that's like, fine. I mean, I got time to do this.
Like, 15 feet in front of him is the entrance to the building, and just like 5 feet in front of him, there's like a street lamp kind of like lighting the area around it. And then
she didn't scream, did she?
No, she didn't even have time to react. She was like, what? And then you just snapped her neck.
Yeah, just gonna do that very quickly and get the fuck out.
Are you gonna leave her body there?
Of
course.
Okay, so are you just gonna, like, tear into her flesh to write this? Are you writing it with the pen?
The lipstick.
The lipstick? Mm-hmm. Okay. And you were also putting whore on her, or...?
Whore, 48 hours, fucking...
No,
J-Q.
Don't put 48 hours, that discriminates me.
Well, I guess not that. Just
no time frames.
You write 48 hours and then you erase it with your palm. Like, oh shit.
Fucking former all for the Republic, down with the Emperor.
Okay.
The King.
Yeah. So you're definitely getting a corruption for this. I'm gonna say you gain 1d10 plus 3 corruption points for this activity.
You can get corruption in Rogue Trader?
Yes.
It's 5.
Wow.
You're pretty lucky there, Chief. Or unlucky, depending on how you want to look at it. I don't know how many corruption points you have right now.
I think I had 1. Yeah, so I got 6.
Okay. yeah. So now the body's on the ground. You're standing in, like, just a lawn right now.
Booking it.
Where are you running to?
Fucking cheesing it. Back the direction I came.
That was the bus stop, you mean?
Yeah, but like, and then fucking booking it. I'm basically just getting as far away from the shit as possible. Then I'll worry about surroundings.
Okay, so you're just gonna sprint through the city away from here.
Sprinting from you away from the immediate scene, then just walking for like a couple, like maybe an hour. Just fucking.
Okay. All right. Okay, so yeah, you're able to get away. There's no one outside. I mean, you don't know. It was dark where you were, but it wasn't, like, pitch black, so you don't know that whether or not someone would have been able to see you. In either case, your face was obscured by your trench coat.
fucking cigarette.
Actually, you leave the teenage girl's corpse in the lawn.
Hit my fedora before I the lady.
And sprint through the night until you arrive a few blocks away. In a kind of like a small shopping district that's all closed up for the night.
Just
dump the gloves and the trench coat and
pretty much
just
fucking
dumpster.
Ditch my clothing, except for, like, you know, I guess my
the fedora.
Pretty much not look shady as fuck anymore.
Okay, yeah, so you can stash it. There's like garbage cans. There's like sewer grates. Where are you throwing
the trash? Will do.
Okay, yeah. You throw it into a dumpster, and yeah. And
that
you just,
might have
not walked your way back to the Imperial Palace.
Demon, you should burn it.
Yeah, fucking flick the cigarette into the dumpster.
Okay.
A low stick.
All right. The contents are somewhat paperish, I guess. So they light a little bit.
Fucking make the Strelic face, then yeah, make my way to the Imperial Palace.
Okay. Yeah, it's gonna take you a couple of hours of walking to get there.
That's fine.
All right. The rest of you, it's like it's now like midnight, and most of the people who are partying have gone off to their rooms or whatever.
Can I roll to see how much better me and buddies the prince became?
Sure.
Oh, can I God. Like that?
You can if you want.
There we go.
At first, you kind of get the sensation that, like, he really fucking hates your guts a lot, and you're just pissing him off by spending time with him. But as he starts drinking more and more, he's like, oh, you're my best friend, bro. And, you know, you don't expect that that's how he'll treat you normally, but you feel that things are better.
Definitely improved.
Yeah. Anyone else doing anything?
I'm desperately trying to not let Matt give me any alcohol.
Yeah, I'm gonna...
Probably failing.
So I'm pretty drunk at this point, right?
Another thing.
You should all tough discuss.
Say I took her wallet also before I ran.
Okay, you took her wallet? Sure. There's like a small amount of currency in there and like a photo ID.
Good.
Picture of her family.
Hide that shit on my person.
Good, that might not be wise.
Covered in semen and then leave at the doorstep.
There's like one of the pictures is like her and her baby brother and she's smiling.
Yeah. Yeah. I bet he has cancer too.
Yeah, he has cancer.
Good.
I bet you just killed like somebody who had nothing to do with anything. You just killed an innocent civilian who probably just fucking swept the floors or some shit.
Red, this is real politics, all right?
All right. Anyway, can I, while I'm on this ship, can I fucking, I don't know, look for some more shit, I guess, or something?
For the purpose of, like, strapping to yourself?
Yeah, or something.
Okay.
It's getting so big.
Yeah, you find more shit you can strap to yourself.
Fuck yeah.
I hope you're not taking our money, Red.
I'm definitely not converting profit factor into armor points right now.
Well, you're
now.
No!
Well, y'all motherfuckers left me on the ship, man.
No, Redhead, like, that's the entire rogue trader profit factor.
Right by now, the time... and he's like, oh, what's this shiny thing? It's like a fucking Archaeotech relic. He's like, man, that'll make a great new pauldron.
No, Redhead.
By the time you guys get back, I'll be a fucking, like, war boss-sized motherfucker with, like, nothing but, like, a giant ball of metal and shit.
Just, like, got computers and shit taped to him.
I'll be like, fucking, what's that fucking game again? Calamari or something where you roll the fucking...
Kind
all
of
around.
Yeah,
dude, I'll be like the giant fucking ball by the time you guys get back.
No, Blood Guzzler, that's not armor, that's all of our profit factor.
Stink-ass armor.
If I could drive the ship right now. Oh my god.
Look with that. I locked that shit.
The keys, the fuzzy dice. Demon took both.
He's got a picture of, his long lost cousin Andrea Breivik.
Yeah.
So she, I guess we'll just we'll let the night pass.
Yeah, I'm gonna fucking. Can I apply that shit to my armor?
No. I have nothing left to do.
You can add another armor.
Shut the fuck up, Matt. You're drunk.
When can I show up?
Well, let's. Okay, so Matt, first you need to make a toughness test and see if you don't like if you're getting drunk as fuck right now. You're decadent, so I think you pass.
I'm unusually like have a super high alcohol tolerance.
Yeah, I think you pass.
So
go ahead. What do you want to do?
So at this point, has the prince left with a girl?
He left with several.
All right. Whoa, well, gone. Who is the most attractive of the leftovers?
There's that girl he pointed you to earlier. She's not bad looking, but. You know.
Hmm. I don't know if this is a good idea or not. I feel like he might have been rusing me.
Just don't.
I mean, all the good-looking girls have pretty much left way before the prince.
Fuck you.
Let's definitely roll for seduction with the plain-looking girl.
Okay.
Fuck. Why?
I mean, she's pretty drunk, so she's like, ah, you're funny.
Yes, this is prime time, baby. But basically, I want to... Now let's just roll for just take it home.
Okay.
And this is building up to something, don't worry. Okay, well...
What are you trying to do right now?
I was going to take her back to my room, but...
That's what you were rolling on right now?
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, you stumble down the hall together laughing, and, you know, you're walking through it, and you're not really sure where you are in the palace.
I'm not that drunk.
You're pretty drunk. You've been drinking for 5 hours straight.
Jesus Christ. I'm not that drunk.
Yeah, you're like fucking uni, you know. You have an enormous alcohol tolerance, but the amount you drink just kind of demolishes it. So it's dark and you can't really see where you're going. You stumble through the halls and you open a door thinking it's your room. You're like, all right.
It's going to be like the princess's room, you fuck. Don't do this to me.
And then, yeah, inside is the princess.
Oh, fuck you.
And she's writing in her little pink diary. And you stumble in there.
All right, I'm going to save this. Okay. I'm gonna get up off the floor because I'm assuming we fell. And I'm gonna say, be gone, foul woman of ill repute. And I'm gonna throw her off me into the hallway. I guess I need to roll a deception.
What, no charm for a threesome? I mean, what the fuck, bro? I don't think you can make it.
Get your mind out of the gutter.
Hey, you're not a very fucking saintly person, I know you.
Strela is the most righteous.
Did I succeed in getting her off of me and putting her in the hallway?
So... When you look into the room more closely, you actually determine that the princess fell asleep writing in her journal. So she's sitting at her desk asleep right now.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, I'm gonna peel this one off me and throw her into the courtyard. Are we on the second floor?
No.
I'll just put her through an archway. And I'm going to gently
stab that bitch.
I feel like if I like roll to like pick her up and like lay her into bed and tuck her in, I'm gonna like stumble and like drop her and she's gonna crack her skull and start bleeding.
Dude, just kill the bitch.
I'm just gonna leave the room and head back to mine.
No, send the entire empire into civil war. Just slash her throat.
That would do a whole lot.
J&L on her forehead.
Yeah, you're strolling back to your
You know, maybe you should, actually.
And you have to cut through one of the gardens while you're here. And as you do so, you see Strelok, extremely shady-looking motherfucker, like, you know, stumbling over a wall into the gardens and, like, doing the Strelok face at you.
At a salute.
I'm going to pretend I don't know
him. You can see he has a wallet on him that's pretty girly as well.
I don't
actually.
Have
can I take? Can I? Can I take the wallet from him?
No, don't fucking carry this thing. Just burn it.
Shut up. Give me the wallet, demon. Want it?
Because I'm thinking about going into the whole sleight of hand thing myself.
Yeah, give me the wallet, demon.
Yeah, sure. Here you go. I'm gonna throw it out.
I'm gonna take it back to my room.
Okay.
And is there a fire pit in there?
Yes. There's fireplaces in all the rooms here.
All right. Well, I'm going to stoke at the fire. I'm gonna throw the wallet into the fire.
Damn you!
Thank God.
Yeah. Crisis averted. Decomposes under the fire. The last thing you see of it is the picture of her and her little brother smiling as it burns into the flame.
I'm going to feverishly masturbate while this occurs.
Fucking stumble into the party chambers and just down a whole thing of wine bottle.
Yeah, Strelok, the only people left in the room are the two ugly girls.
Fuck you.
Right down and I'm gonna fucking send the bottle sailing towards them.
No, don't stop. I'm passed out.
They just giggle at the prospect of it.
Like, how could I fucking be giggling?
No, you're not one of the ugly girls.
Oh, okay, I thought this was just a joke.
Are you still in the party chamber?
Yeah.
Passed out in there?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, you also see Card in there.
Roll for seduction on Card. Date rape. Alright, I think we can all... Can we all agree to progress to the next day?
Yes, please.
Okay. So,
Strelick passed out on the floor after downing that shit.
After the night of murder and debauchery, God. You wake up and, you know, it just seems like business as usual at the palace.
Should we inform anyone about what went down?
No. We have no idea what they're talking about.
I'm going to, I want to high-five
well,
my...
Well, Matt is fucking running the investigation, so...
First off, I want to head for the nearest, like, phone. But first I want to go down the hall and high-five my bro, the prince, for a job well done last night with all those babes.
Yeah, it's 11 a.m. He's still sleeping right now.
All right, well, I'm going to, like, you know, shoot him a creepy smile through the doorway of his room. So he's slightly engaged.
Okay. Yeah, he's a sleepy kid.
I'm going to head for the phone. I'm going to dial up the chancellor. Assuming I ever on speed dial.
Okay, yeah. You dial the chancellor's office, and the receptionist answers, and she's like, hello.
Long time no see, baby girl. Is Chancellor around?
Ah, it's you. Yeah, give me a moment.
I'm bonding with people.
Yeah, so
that girl I tried to seduce is going to turn out to be like the wife of Shlomo Finkelstein. Just further kindling for the flames, the ultimate enemy.
So you are put on hold for a little while, and eventually the Chancellor picks up. You can hear... She's like, what? What is it? There's a very big emergency going on.
I'm going to say...
Strelick face.
I'm going to say... I'm going to say, this isn't a secure line, so we can't talk here, but I know what's going on.
Okay, well, then you need to meet me immediately.
All right, well, I'm going to go meet her then.
Yeah.
Just me.
You're going to set off to do that. What are the rest of you doing?
Passed out.
I'm going to start looking for a helmet.
Trying to not look ridiculous.
You find a football helmet.
I'm fucking fine with that.
Yeah.
How much armor does it give me?
It's 1 AP.
Probably. Beautiful. Thank you.
Just fucking bumbling around the rogue trader ship.
Yeah, he's just fucking up there alone. It's amazing the crew hasn't spotted him. Really. He's just kind of like completely unaware that he's stealthing through chambers that are normally active. Card, what are you doing?
At the moment, I don't think I'll be doing anything. Probably trying to clean the one good pair of clothes I have.
Okay.
After wearing it and then falling on the ground. Probably in, like, a puddle of puke.
Okay, alright. So, yeah, I guess Matt's the only one really awake and active. So he's headed off to meet with the Chancellor. And, yeah, you show up at the Executive Mansion again and go to... You see her, like, just waiting for you at the entrance this time. Yeah, she's, like, waving for you to come over.
Alright, well, I'm gonna walk over to her.
Once I'm done doing that, I'm going to search out for, I'm going to ask the prince who is the best doctor in the land.
Prince is still passed out, right?
Yeah,
he's not going to wake up until, like, afternoon, really.
When he's awake. Well, I'm still cleaning, so.
That's okay. You said what, Matt?
I'm going to, like, bow slightly and be like, tell me everything you know. So.
All right, well, first she takes you into the conference room that you were in before.
Kinky.
Okay. she says, well, first off, the murder last night. There's a body. Secretary. Actually, secretary of our Senate Majority Leader. And some pretty...
Gasp.
Some pretty... ridiculous things carved into it. By carved into it, I mean written in pin on it, I guess.
Right? Really? I thought Demon was carving it into her flesh.
Yeah, I thought he was doing that too.
This is the
literally case. Wrote it with lipstick.
Okay, yeah, lipstick, yeah. Written in lipstick all over it.
Yes, I wasn't aware of the things being written, but I have news for you.
Yes, what is it?
Well, you see, I anticipated this, but by the time I saw that the wheels were already set in motion, it was far too late. But I did have an agent start to tail the assailant at the very last moment. What's Justice and Unicy's colors? Green.
Green.
Yeah. And they weren't able to ascertain much because the assailant was very, very heavily armed and very large. But he did say that underneath his trench coat, he saw a flash of green clothing.
I see. That's most disconcerting.
Do you see where I'm coming from on this whole issue? This is nothing to be lightly taken.
I think I understand what you're trying to do here.
I'm gonna, like, at this point, I'm gonna, like, sit back and, like, cross my legs, like, Indian style. Just be like, so what do you think we should do?
Well, I think we need more evidence if this is going to be taken into the public eye. But I see now that your concerns were properly placed. The investigation will have the full support of my administration.
So can we extend our discretion clause, as now you can see that we can't allow this to leak out for risking the investigation?
I think that's reasonable, yes. As long as it helps to prevent further incidents such as these.
Wonderful. I already have agents further investigating the plot to assassinate her murder by this the whole time I'm doing this. I'm doing the Birdman hand rub. A dove appears outside of a near window.
Just as planned.
Yes. Yeah, Matt, you gain one corruption point.
Oh. What? Why?
No, you're fine. Not really. I mean, your soul is slowly being blackened by all these.
That's
things.
My first corruption point, so.
I already have 7.
That's good. Yeah, so she's responded that way. What do you have anything else you want to tell her?
And so I'm gonna say, I think in the meantime that you should, completely unrelated to this, don't give anything, but I think you should start a legislative push for a harsher crackdown on the terroristic organization.
I agree entirely. I'll see to it that, we don't have control of the House, but even freedom and development should understand in the wake of the crisis.
Perhaps if we start to put the pressure on them militarily, we can distract their focus from these horrible terrorist efforts, and perhaps if we can find the perpetrator behind this crime, we can get some greater insight.
Yes, indeed.
Well, until then, I have to get back to my investigation, so I bid you adieu, and at this point, I'm going to kiss her hand again and leave.
Okay, yeah, she's still uncomfortable with it, but...
Slap her on the ass on the way out, too.
Oh, dear.
I'm not going to do that. That was a joke. I'm going to think about it in my head, and I'm going to get a little aroused, but then I'm gonna leave. So. All right, well, at this point, I'm going to head back to the palace.
Okay. Yeah, it's like probably noon now after that. 12:30, more realistic.
Is the prince awake?
No, he's still asleep.
God,
he won't
damn it.
Be awake for a couple of hours at least.
Can
you
I just
wake him up?
Don't do that.
I think the scene in his room might be a little lewd.
Yes.
Can I ask the princess if she awake?
Greer?
Yes.
There's two of them, so.
When I would say the princess, I just mean her.
Okay, yeah, she's awake.
I'll ask her, please, one of my friends is in dire need of assistance, and I need the best medicine man that you have.
Medicine man.
Doctor? I mean,
or maybe
sure,
medicine woman.
There's plenty of excellent doctors.
I mean the best.
That really kind of depends. I mean, some of them are much better at other, you know, certain things than others.
Who's the best at heresy?
Heresy? What?
heresy!
Religion, what's going on?
At this point, am I back at the palace shit?
Yeah.
Alright, well, I'm gonna walk into the princess's room. I'm gonna be like, ignore my friend. He's a little slow of the mind. Or she's slow of the mind.
I
just slit the fucker's throat already.
Shut up, Matt!
At this point, I'm gonna pick you up and, like, move you out of the room. I'm much larger than you. I'm gonna ask the princess how she slept.
I look very frustrated.
She says,
still passed out on a couch.
I fell asleep at my desk. It was unfortunate.
What were you writing there?
Oh, you know, it's a woman's secret.
Well, I'm gonna like smile knowingly. I'm gonna say, "Well, we all have secrets, don't we?" And then I'm gonna do the bird thing.
Yeah, some of us a little bit more dangerous than others.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm gonna
ask her if she'd like to get lunch today, and then we can cut to what the rest of them are doing. Do I need to roll a charm on that?
No, she says fine. All right, everybody else.
I need a damn doctor.
Okay, yeah. I mean, yeah, she can recommend you. I mean, the palace has
the best one possible.
It really just depends on, like, what you're trying
to
do.
You know what I'm trying to do.
I have no idea what you're
trying
to do.
We have a certain man aboard our ship.
Oh.
Who's a little on the insane side. Hasn't been with us for a while.
I'm going to start sharpening my chopper.
I'm not talking about you.
No, I was not talking about Red. I was talking about.
That's
I was talking about Sirius.
Oh, okay. I mean, sure. Yeah, you can find a very good doctor.
Yeah. I assume I'm able to contact my ship.
Yeah.
Like NDT, I'll tell him I need a ship, someone to bring this doctor to our ship to look over the man.
Do you
to
just
look
give
over Sirius.
Fucking the right to control the ship when you're not around? Is that how it works? He's second in command?
I don't know who else would be second in command.
I mean,
Milton Ekron.
Technically speaking, in the hierarchy, like, the person who drives the ship is Ryan Gosling.
Okay, Ryan Gosling. I'll phone him up and tell him what I just said. I'd tell him to send, like, a lander.
Okay, yeah.
Down, get the doctor, bring him back, have him look at Sirius, don't reveal anything spooky.
Okay, I mean, sure, yeah, you could totally do all that.
Okay. Yeah.
That'll be a process that happens independently of you guys.
Yeah, I just want to have that happen.
Okay.
I'm going to go to the Congress building.
Okay. Demon, yeah?
Wake up and change clothes and then, like, start scrutinizing the staff just walking all over the Imperial Palace.
So you make the face at them, or...?
I mean, just, like... Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Alright, Card, you start your way over to the Congressional Headquarters.
I'm trying to look for Mrs. Muahua Mizuhashi.
The person whose secretary you killed.
Yes, Mrs. Mizuhashi.
Okay, well, she's not in today at all. She is taking leave of absence due to personal issues, which she's declined to make public.
Is her office open?
No, it's closed.
Fuck. Can I get access to it? Is the secretary, is the receptionist here?
Of the entire building? Yes.
Yeah. Could she get me access into her office? Like, how does it work? Is it, like, lock and key, or...
It what? Is a key card system, but, I mean, she has access to all of the offices.
Okay,
but
I guess...
it would be extraordinary for someone to get into the office of a, you know, a member of Congress without their knowledge.
I'm going to, Matt, wish you were fucking here. Well, actually, maybe... Matt, you should probably get access to this office from the president woman.
All right, I'm gonna hit up my Asami. Bay chancellor on my cell.
Okay, Yeah, I mean, also, you guys totally got cell phones when you came here. You don't have to use, you know, because they have fucking cellular infrastructure.
Yeah, fuck that shit. Heretical. All right,
well, I'm going to hit up the chancellor and be like, so, I have suspicions that the lady who's going to be assassinated, that her office may be rigged, not to explode or anything drastic like that, but I think it may be rigged with bugs in an effort to
scare her. She's afraid of insects, you see.
Fuck you. To gain more info on her day-to-day movements. While she's off for today, do you think we could check this out?
Absolutely. She, you know, she right. informs the office that you have permission to enter there.
All right.
Yeah, I'll just go up to the receptionist and, you know, stealthily address who I am. Which really means not very stealthily.
I guess I'll be with Card. I'm going to catch up to Card.
Sure. So. Strelok, are you going too?
No, he's not. That's the worst idea
no. ever. Yeah. Strelok no, needs no. to lay low forever.
I'm basically just, like, casing out the palace. Also, okay. seeing it, you know, if I notice anything interesting about staff members or.
Okay.
Yeah. So what is in her office? Assuming she just lets us in.
Is there any cameras in the office?
There's cameras outside of the office. There's not a camera in the office. Like any kind of, you know, that sort of surveillance okay. equipment is not allowed in the office of a. Congress member.
So we're basically A-OK in here. Like, yeah. There's no way they can view our actions.
Correct.
There's no windows.
I mean, there's a window to the outside.
I'll yeah. close the blinds.
They were already closed, but sure.
I double close them.
Alright. So the way this works is basically the receptionist takes you back there. She's been briefed on it, and she hands you the key card to it. She says to return it when you're done.
Sure.
Ooh, I have a good idea. Alright, Card, go to, or no, I'll do this. Card, you just, like, dig around the office, see if you can find anything interesting. I'm going to leave and say that I need something relevant to the investigation. And, do they have a hardware store here?
In Congress?
No, like, I mean, like, nearby.
I mean, there's definitely hardware stores in the city. I don't know if there'd be any near the administrative district. Probably be a half-hour bus trip away.
Is there like a 7-Eleven or anything?
There's like a convenience store, sure, fairly close, a couple of blocks.
Alright, I'm gonna walk there.
Okay.
Alright, so once I'm inside, do they sell like duct tape here?
Yes.
Alright, do they sell, duct tape? What else do we need? I wanna buy the cell phone off of,
anything interesting happened?
The cashier.
No.
You want to buy her cell phone?
Yes.
Okay, well, she's like, why would I sell you my cell phone?
I just want to flash her $1,000.
It's like, oh, okay, that works.
All right, cool. So I'm going to take her cell phone now.
Okay.
And at this point, I want to head back to the office. I want to, with the duct tape and the cell phone.
Okay. Fuck.
All right, yeah. And so at this point,
What's in the office?
There's two rooms. The first room is the waiting room where the receptionist sat. The other room is behind another interior door, which is the office of the actual senator herself. And it's nicer. It has a large, nice wooden desk. Another terminal embedded into the desk. There's, like, a globe, which represents the planet of Serenity. There's, you know, like, a bunch of documents filed away into a, like, inbox-outbox sort of, you know, thing. There's
Am I back at the office yet?
Sure.
Right, so,
I think, I don't know, these people don't have micro-bead and vox technology, right?
Not specifically those technologies, but I mean, they have, like...
I mean, what I'm basically saying...
And cell phones. Jesus.
Yeah, no, I...
Either do
but...
me or Card have the capability to, like, mess with technology?
I am extremely smart. I don't have tech use, but I do a 55 intelligence.
Okay, well, can Card try to can Card try to hack the phone so it looks like it's being used as a recording device?
It's actually 24.
That would be extraordinarily complicated. Now, okay, so you're saying to hack the phone to make it do what exactly?
Just record the audio from the surrounding area.
Yeah, I'm thinking that would be a pretty... I mean,
I don't even think I need to hack that. Surely that's just something that the phone can do.
Yeah, they,
I just have to figure out how to make it work.
Features like that. Yeah, you...
Basically, I just... Matt just gave an iPhone to, like, his 80-year-old grandmother and said, record me.
I mean, you... Holy shit, sir. If you need to fucking mute your microphone. I mean, so it's a fairly... It's designed to be user-friendly. But I mean, like, you could enable the recording app on the phone. You can't hack it to make it a surveillance device.
Are you gonna delete all that bitch's context and shit off of that?
Yeah, I'm willing to, I'm gonna delete all the data on the phone.
Okay.
And, basically, I want to go, can we, does she have, like, a book of phone numbers? Like, a directory? Or office?
Yes, she has, like, a little, you know, one of those, what are they, like, Rolodex or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to delete all the contacts and all the data, completely wipe the phone.
Okay.
And, I want to basically just put one contact in the phone.
Okay.
And I want it to have...
Justice and Unity Party Headquarters.
No,
no,
just
not the headquarters.
It,
I want to have the personal
unlist
number
it.
Of their leader.
Of Miyuki Sawashiro?
Yeah.
Well, you don't know her personal phone number. You could have the phone number to her congressional office.
Hmm, that seems shady. If we
just have it unlisted and have the phone number be something completely
irrelevant.
Yeah, have one completely, like, have an unlisted number. So.
Okay.
Alright. And, at this point, I want to place a piece of duct tape over the phone, like the keyboard of the phone, or like just the front of the phone screen.
Okay.
And I want to put it on the wall in like a really obscure spot, and then I want to rip it off so it removes a little of the paint.
Okay.
And at this point, I want to call the chancellor from my cell phone.
All right. Go ahead, guard, first a little bit. What were you going to say?
I was going to ask... again, what I was going off of, the microbead thing, these people don't know what that is at all, right?
They don't, no, they don't use Vox technology at all.
Maybe we could just use the microbead instead to,
to act like it's a bug?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a way better idea. Yeah, forget the cell phone idea.
Okay. Are
Damn,
you still calling the Chancellor?
Should we? Kurt? Say it's a bug we found?
Yes.
So, like, actually.
Or,
better
idea.
Get some sticky tag.
We could say we found the cell phone in a dumpster and that there's only one unmarked number in it and that we found the bug in the office. That's two pieces of evidence.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Yeah. So, what we should really do is we should make the number and the phone be like some obscure office of the Justice and Unity Party on like a really on that terrorist planet.
Morale?
Yeah.
Can the cellular devices? Yeah.
Can it?
No, definitely not.
Don't you need like fucking psychers to do that shit?
Well, no, they have information relays set up so that the planets themselves are very short distances from each other because the gravitic drive can't warp that far, comparatively. But they have basically like a fucking relay beacon network set up to transmit information. But it only transmits information every time a new merchant ship enters the system.
All right, fine. We'll just go with the beat. Forget the cell phone. That was a waste of time.
I have a phone number for a different planet.
I don't know. You can still have it there.
What's that?
Just leave the cell phone there. In her office, like behind.
On record.
Yeah.
Yeah. But won't it look suspicious when it's been recording for exactly the time since we've been there?
Well, I mean, no, I wasn't going to say recording. Just leave it, like, open. And if it, assuming it's an iPhone, make sure to buy the new iPhone 6, iPhone S.
iPhone 17.3.
A really big screen.
Only on Trinity. The screen is actually 15 inches wide. It's very hard to obscure.
But
phone, like, bedazzled and shit, or...
From the 7-Eleven person? No, it's just like it's got like a little girly phone cover, but it's not bedazzled.
Well, I mean,
all right, we'll take off the damn phone cover, Jesus Christ. And then we're gonna duct tape it to the wall, I guess, in that spot.
Okay.
Behind a plant.
And, you know, kick like a plant behind it, and at this point, I'm gonna call the Chancellor.
Okay.
Everybody should make
a point to hide their microbeads at this point.
Yeah, we should really do
that. I'm pretty sure I'm the only one who had one anyway.
I have one.
Oh, God.
At this point, yeah, throw yours the damn fire demon, Jesus Christ.
Swallow it.
Those spirit stones, they're waiting to come back.
We'll get to that, don't worry.
Anyway, I'm on the phone with the Chancellor, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to say we found something. And we found a bug in her office.
I see.
And the technology, it's significantly different than the one you guys use. It's almost similar to the type of technology we use in the Imperium.
That's bug. Interesting. Would that be the case, you think?
I think that you might have...
Say maybe the Moral group is getting assistance from fucking chaos cultists or something. Some bullshit.
My theory is that the Moral terrorist and by extension the Justice and Unity Party may be working with outside cultists to overthrow the Empire with the help of chaos cultists.
Chaos's reach has no bound.
They're a religious organization in the Imperium that seeks out to destroy anyone who disagrees with the Empire religiously or politically.
Ah, yes.
I see. Well, that's very disturbing.
Yeah. So we're going to keep looking around here, but we should just thought you should know we found the bug. So.
Well, there's some other news on my end as well. Tomorrow, the Justice and Unity Party leader is scheduled to give a speech on the Senate floor.
Was this just announced?
It was just announced.
What is the speech about?
I don't really know the content, but suffice to say, it happened more or less at the same time as news of the murder from last night. I only have just actually gotten word back from my sources about it now, though.
Well, they're most likely going to be launching into damage control mode. I think it's important we keep our heads on straight and look at the facts here. The evidence is mounting. First the murder, a bug in the office. I mean, who else would bug her office?
I'm exactly. Gonna start doing push-ups in the ship.
Yeah.
I'm getting ready.
Get ready to kill.
So fucking November 5th, that speech.
So, basically, she's like, definitely keep me informed. I think it would be very prudent for the investigation to monitor that speech. Who knows what they'll do next.
Right. Demon, you should, like, set up across the street on the roof of the church and, like, aim your sniper rifle through a window right on the head of the woman.
More like Maya, fucking soulless.
And then I should like assassinate someone like standing next to her.
Yeah, you know,
we
maybe
should assassinate the person we're going to during the speech.
Ah.
We're not killing the speaker.
No, not the speaker. We should kill the woman we're going to do. We should kill her during the speech.
Well, she might not even be there. And also, she will, do we really want to be killing popular stability members?
Yes, we do. Yes. We want to be killing all the political party members.
Well, I mean...
This is the plan, Demon. Get with it. I have a new plan for the cell phone. So at this point, I want to...
Damn it, fuck the cell phone!
No, shut up. I have a new plan. At this point, I want to place a single phone call.
Yeah, Surf, start making bombs, Surf.
Surf, I don't know how you plan to smuggle fucking explosives into the congressional headquarters.
He's purposely going to get caught and then hung. Like, yep, it was chaos cultists. Working with the Justice and Unity League.
Yeah, actually, maybe we could get one of our crew members to do that.
I mean, I have an idea.
We could totally, like, set up a false flag and then bust ourselves, but of course we're not going to be ourselves more. Busting ourselves, if you get what I'm saying.
what I'm saying is instead of killing the speaker, we should kill somebody who looks like they're going to assassinate the speaker and plant the cell phone on them after we placed one call to the Justice and Unity Party today.
Sure. Fine.
Okay, so what was that, Redhead?
Can I look for a minigun?
A minigun?
I'm joking.
I mean, I got the ballistic skill if we're going to be shooting someone in the head from a clock tower.
All right, so we're going to need one of our random lackeys from the ship, and we're going to tell him that
you guys have death cult members.
Yeah, they're definitely going to get the death cult member. Absolutely.
But so what exactly is your plan right now?
Well, first off, Surf, can you build an explosive, or do you have one? I mean, I guess we could just roll with frag grenades.
best of them.
Yeah. It's like four frag grenades.
Combat vest and make a fucking grenade belt.
Yeah, you can look like the demo man. Build his vest. I'm assuming we could just take like four frag grenades. We don't need Surf to build explosives. But how are we going to get this person in the building?
Okay, right, so maybe we don't want the assassin to actually shoot. Jesus Christ, Surf, this isn't complicated. So what we're going to do is we're going to set Demon up on a roof, like way far, as far away as like possible for him to still hit the shot easily. And we're going to put the fake assassin, on the roof close to this place. And they're going to take aim at the the popular stability lady we're going to assassinate during the speech tomorrow. Okay?
Some John F. Kennedy shit.
we're going to make that person have the cell phone on them, and they're going to see that one call we placed to the main headquarters of the Justice and Unity Party today. And then when they're shot, that's going to be the only thing they have on their person besides the weapon they were going to fire.
Okay, so let me clear something up right now.
I'm going to be blasting this fucker.
The Senate floor is in a fucking building, you know. A sniper
will leave the roof of the building. Hold on. They've got to leave the building at some point, don't they?
They do. I mean, well, yes, that's true.
But I assume it has multiple... inside. Yeah, I assume it has multiple floors, though, in the actual Senate hall. Like, the shooter...
Why don't we wait for all of them to leave?
The fake assassin could just sit in, like,
I'll be in the speech, I think, and you guys are all posted up, you know, keeping watch and shit. And
what you should do is you should be walking next to this lady and then like fucking guard thing when the gunshots start going.
That's actually great. I'm gonna be walking next to the lady out of the building. I'm gonna be like, "Ma'am, I think there's a threat to your security."
You're gonna say that to the Justice and Unity person?
Yeah, and then like,
and then flash a Strelok face.
Pull the trigger, and then Demon's gonna pull the trigger. It's gonna blow everyone's mind. We have saved her life, and it's the Justice and Unity Party's fault. This is brilliant.
I thought you're talking about the popular stability lady, right?
No. I mean, we're gonna tell the assassin to kill the Justice and Unity woman, but you're gonna actually shoot the deaf cultist.
Yeah.
Man. Okay. Yeah. Does he know we're gonna?
I don't think that was correct. I thought he was going to assassinate popular stability later, but I was going to shoot him before he does that.
I don't think it matters who he thinks he's gonna shoot
well,
at.
Yeah, I mean,
Demon shoots him beforehand.
Yeah, it doesn't. Because really
I'm gonna be giving the order to shoot him.
Should just tell him that it's like a Zeech priest leader.
Yeah, that's a perfect idea. I tell him I'm gonna give him that cell phone. I'm gonna tell him I'm gonna call you on the cell phone when it's time to pull the trigger.
Hmm.
And then we're gonna blow his brains out.
Okay, so are you actually gonna? Are you planning to kill anybody? Or are you
just,
no, we're not
just,
planning to kill any political leaders, just the cultists.
Okay. Just the
your
death cult
guy,
member.
You're gonna fucking
I mean, he's part of a death cult, so he probably knew this was coming.
Yeah.
So okay. can we fast forward time?
Well, I mean, we're filling him in on this whole plan, right? I mean, he won't mind dying.
He's totally willing to die. If he thinks that, I mean, he does. He's definitely willing to do what you say, even if it means
I will.
Plan, then.
Yeah, to make it as convincing as possible.
Yeah.
And that he is supposed to be one of these Morale terrorists.
Yeah.
And also some rah-rah shit about serving the Emperor.
Yeah.
It's for the great, I almost said the greater good, that would have been bad.
God.
okay.
So who is sneaking the two sniper rifles in?
They don't have to be in the building. I thought we're posting up and waiting for like the speech to be over and everybody's leaving.
Yeah.
Okay. But again, how are we getting them onto the planet? I thought the thing about this city was it was like a strict no guns allowed.
Well, I'll just call
sure, we can
the
just,
Chancellor.
Like, flash some papers around. Yeah. And, I'm sure dude can get a sniper rifle from like the underground market or something.
Or we could just go through official channels. I'm gonna call up the Chancellor right now.
Well, I don't think it would look very good
well,
if a sniper rifle
what?
Was using those no
cars. Yeah.
A personally requisition the gun that you use to try and assassinate with. Our investigation needs this.
Alright, well, we need to get one from her, and then we need to buy another one on the black market.
Okay. Well, if you guys are gonna try and interact with the black market, that's gonna be a basically, it's acquisition, but you need to specify how you're going to try to do that.
I think it's probably best if I try to do this. I'm probably the best actual trading member.
We have a sniper on the ship?
You guys have lots of sniper rifles on the ship.
Yeah, but they're all like Imperial sniper rifles. They probably have their own.
You said that the cultists were most likely working with the terrorist organization, so it all makes perfect sense.
Maybe we can get like Morale-esque customization tactical attachments. Slap it on the sniper rifle.
We could, like, paint heretical shit on it.
Well, no, that'll defeat the purpose. That won't mean anything. That would be totally pointless.
Like chaos symbols.
Like, why
shit.
Is there barbed
yeah,
wire dildos all over this sniper rifle?
That doesn't. That won't. That really doesn't help that much.
I just say.
I mean, you
just
can
smuggle it off the ship.
Sure,
well, I mean,
that's fine. It's just
a connection with like Morale and
the
terrorists, the
cultists
like,
and
outside cultists.
Yeah,
I'm
just saying if we add on more to it. Right now it just seems like, oh, the cultists killed this woman, not Morale, not the Justice and Unity people, or rather the person trying to kill the Justice and Unity woman.
It doesn't matter because no one's actually getting killed. We're killing them before they get the chance.
Yeah, but if we just kill him, it seems like we just killed a cultist. Like, not someone who's an actual Morale Justice and Unity sympathizer. Someone who's just doing this.
Well, it doesn't matter. He could be a hired gun from the support of the cultist.
I think it really won't take that much extra time to just add on, like, a Morale flag onto it.
Well,
you know?
I'm not against that at all.
That I mean, that's just what I'm saying we should do.
Yeah, well, I mean, let's... I mean, how hard can it be to find a to make it look like a Morale sniper rifle?
Fucking have this guy get
probably extremely hard
Republic tattooed across his arm or something.
Actually, that's not a horrible idea. Can we tattoo some Morale symbol on him?
Long live the Republic, death to the king, something like that.
All right, let's do that. All right, first we need to commission R1 sniper rifle for Demon, though. So I'm gonna hit up the bay and be like. So, based on the information we've extracted from this bug here, We think that something might be eclipsing during the speech tomorrow.
I see. What do you propose to do about it?
I think because of the very high security, and I hope you'll be taking care of that in the Senate building, that I think you're safe inside of there, but I think you should be careful when you're leaving the building. But there's no need to cause alarm or rise panic, because luckily on my investigation team here, I have literally one of the best snipers in the Imperium. I want to say literally, too. Like, so she really has not serious. And if I'm going to need to requisition one of your finest sniper rifles to set up a counter-sniping operation from a rooftop nearby.
Very well. Just make sure nothing goes wrong.
Of course. And then I'll just hang up. So, do we have our sniper now? Does it, like, come, like, UPS to us?
So, the weapons they use are magnetic rifles. And this is the stats of a regular one. I guess a sniper rifle version would basically be the same, except it would be a longer range. So.
It would not be gyro-stabilized either.
Wouldn't it?
I don't think so.
I mean, I think...
That's not a trait of any other sniper rifle.
A gyro stabilization, I thought, was just a straight upgrade. Improves accuracy.
Sure. I mean, if it's an attachment...
This thing, I'm gonna shoot
it. It's not an attachment. It's just an incorporation of the weapon design. I'm going to go look it up. But I think that's the way it is. Anyways, yeah, that's the sniper rifle they gave you. It's a mag rifle.
You should definitely hold on to this forever, Demon. In fact, you should use it to shoot the president in the head.
Yeah.
When the day comes.
Say something about, like, flying so good.
Alright, so, can we
start to... She didn't fly so good!
Can we, can we start to, like, set up our operation now, tomorrow? Can we all... I think we all go return to the palace for the night.
Yeah.
And, first we need to snuggle out the sniper rifle.
Yeah, let's do that now.
Let's me and, like, Card return to the ship. Demon, you lay low all night at the palace. Carl, let's return to the ship.
Are we bringing the sniper rifle with us? Are we bringing the death cultist?
That's staying with Demon. The death cultist is on the ship, is he not?
He's on our ship in space.
Yeah,
this guy just needs to be getting ready to die.
Let's just go to the ship real quick.
Okay.
And while we're on there, let's have him tattoo Merwal onto his chest.
Yes, good Goyim.
Okay, I mean, your role for that, Callie?
No, he's totally willing to fucking do it. He doesn't have any qualms whatsoever about...
Alright, so his Morale tattoo...
He knows not to shoot, right?
Yeah.
He will do exactly as you have been
shooting. Let's just say we briefed him on everything. So.
Very convenient.
Okay, so you're waiting till tomorrow first, right? So, I mean, it was only like 2 p.m. after you investigated that.
Well, let's just say this is we waited till we went back to the palace until nighttime, and me and Carter are on the ship at nighttime, and Demon is laying low at the palace with the sniper rifle.
Okay.
And so let's pick a sniper rifle.
Can Demon see the front of the Congressional building? Or at least can he shoot where the deaf cultist guy is going to be standing?
So yeah. How far away are you trying to be from the entrance to the building?
I mean, the deaf cultist, he should be, like, there. It should look like it was really kind of sloppy.
That's what I was planning. He should be on, like,
the buildings around the Congressional building are executive administration buildings, so they're basically just straight-up, like, blocks with several floors. They're much taller than the actual Congressional headquarters.
So let's just have him scale one of these buildings.
Maybe we can have Redhead go along with him and just kill anyone who gets in the way. I mean, at 2 a.m.
in the night and just, like, camp up there.
Yeah,
I mean, if you drop him off at night, there's no one around. So
that was the idea, So he can just sleep there during the night. And let's just, like, how would we smuggle a sniper rifle back to the planet? Would that be that hard?
I mean, if assuming we're, like, black opsing this guy onto the planet in the same go, it'd probably just be with him.
Yeah.
Maybe we can just have like an Aquila lander just hover above the building, and then he just jumps out.
Could we bribe the guard?
Because I imagine it's pretty lightly guarded. Very basic grav chutes that are normally reserved for your elite troops. I guess you could use one of them for him, and he could just you know, just jump out.
Just fucking push his ass out of the lander while flying over the area.
Okay. Yeah, definitely.
Can we do that?
Yeah.
Maybe. Does the lander have any kind of cloaking, or can we, like, mark it up so that way it has no symbols of our ship on it?
It doesn't even need symbols. It's very obviously your technology. It would not be confused for one of theirs. But, I mean...
Well, I meant,
since
like...
Since he's jumping out, you're just flying...
And I mean, like, I don't want someone to look at the lander and be like... And read it saying, you know, Alessandra Sadaban's lander, everyone...
I mean,
if we're just doing a flyover and he's jumping out, Black Ops style, I don't think it's going to be that suspicious. It's nighttime, they can't fucking see.
Basically, since the Congressional Headquarters is like a couple of blocks from the Imperial Palace, and that's where you land, you can play it off as more or less just making a flight down to the surface again from your ship.
Sure, let's do it. Execute. Plan. Right. Saving Private Ryan.
Okay. So yeah, he grab shoots out and lands on top of one of the executive administration buildings. So he'll be there.
And we'll tell him, like, kill anyone who comes up.
Does he have a microbead?
God, I hope so.
Yes, he does. He does. All
right. Give him a microbead so him and Demon can communicate.
Okay.
I don't know if that's such a good idea.
No, yeah, that's a good idea because we've established that they have the microbead technology and it's not important. They're never going to search you. Yeah. So,
I'll never search you, Demon.
Basically, if you like miss your shot, he needs to be able to like shoot himself or something. You see what I'm saying?
I don't think I'm gonna miss.
I'm just saying, but that just—it's more evidence. If like they found a bug in the office,
yeah,
and the cell phone.
And overall, that's a good idea, but I don't think I'm gonna miss.
Let's right, just well,
I,
get to
I
the
think it's
speech.
A good idea.
Okay, so the next day arrives and. The speech is going to be delivered at noon in the building. So
I'll be attending in person.
So, I will be too.
All right. So you guys show up early, I'm guessing? Or?
I'm going to be on top of another one of those big block buildings. I'm assuming I flash some papers to get to the top.
Yeah, you are like, you're totally approved to go and check it out.
Be posted up, aiming at this guy. He's fucking smoking another low stick.
He has the cell phone, the microbead, and the Morale tattoo on him, right? Everything's okay?
Yep. Okay. Okay, so yeah, you guys showed up early to the congressional speech, and
I'm gonna walk over to the chancellor like as she's like walking in, I'm like whisper like we'll see how this goes, and just walk back off into my random spot wherever I am. Where am I in the speech room?
So there's only 14 senators, but there's lots of chairs in here because there's press and stuff. So like I don't know, it's. There's probably like 50 chairs in this room, and there's one lectern at the center. So,
is there anyone with the Imperial family there?
None of the royal family are in attendance, no.
Okay, then me and Carl should sit somewhere random then.
I mean, you could have asked the princess to go, and she'd probably go with you if you wanted.
No,
right
she
now.
Doesn't need to see this.
No, there's no
terrible
there's
bloodshed.
No to expose my virgin bride.
Who knows? Maybe the terrorists will actually bomb the Senate building.
That would be great.
They'll just do it for us.
God, that'd be awful.
That would be great.
It'd be terrible.
It would certainly be weird.
I mean, we would not be looking for that anyways. So that could happen. We didn't even actually investigate anything.
Don't give Callie any ideas. I can see the troll wheel turning his head. Alright, well, let's just fast forward to the start of the speech.
Alright, so yeah, basically everyone is getting into position. All of the senators are in attendance today, including, Kaori Mizuhashi, the woman who, the secretary you killed.
I guess I'll be by her side.
Okay. One second. So you see Miyuki go up to the lectern, and there's cameras, in the back of the room.
Can we get, like, the token for her?
Yeah. Loading the token.
This has been a very imagination-heavy roleplay. There's not been a map in a while.
There's been a great map. You see that map? It's fucking great. Yeah, so... there's.
I almost feel bad about what I'm gonna do when I see her face.
One second,
You really should just let Red do this. He can't get corruption. He should have executed the woman.
No one's dying aside from the heretic.
No, I meant the 18-year-old secretary.
Hey, oh, fuck that.
So, she starts giving her speech, and the contents of the speech are really kind of mundane. Like, they're about generally how the terrorists on Miral need to be put down, and how popular stability has been blocking any sort of bipartisan agreement to, you know, actually increase security presence along the planet.
I'm gonna text the Chancellor while it's going on damage control. Like House of Cards
hashtag
style.
Damage control. Yeah. She mentions also that today is an important day for her personally, since her younger brother is going to be arriving along with a lot of people from Miral to go on a tour
yes.
Of the house, and she's going to be in attendance there. She's kind of hyping it up for the rest of the audience to kind of like give it publicity. She kind of like concludes by making a partisan remark about how, like, you know, again, popular stability is worthless. They are not at all doing what's in the interests of the Empire. And she, you know, concludes her speech, and you know, the floor is opened up, and nobody really had anything planned for today because they expected it to be more significant. The Chancellor is kind of just like, wow, this is what it was. With no other speeches planned for the day, the Senate will conclude its business, and you know, all of the wonderful business that they are doing that is obviously very productive body. But yeah, they're gonna end their session.
All right.
Well, at this point, is everyone gonna file out the front?
Mission Ryan Gosling is a go.
I mean, people are kind of filtering out. The tour that's gonna be happening, there's a lot of people who are gonna attend that as well because they have family members that are involved in that. There's kind of a line of people that have formed. Yuki Saoshiro is obviously like the most prominent of them. But also in attendance is Kana Sumi. She has another sibling from Miral who will be attending. She's the minority leader in the house. You know, various other more minor members of Congress are kind of in that line of people.
Matt.
Yeah.
Should we inform the secretary woman? Not the secretary woman, what the hell am I saying? The popular stability leader, the Senate leader. Mizuhuhishe, that you know, she's being, you know, bad shit's going down.
I think
she needs to head. Surprise.
I don't think she'll attend the tour because she's still grieving, and I imagine she's pretty freaked out still. Is she attending the tour?
Yeah, she's totally gonna go. Like, after that speech, basically all of the Senate has been kind of forced to go because they're going to look bad if they don't do it after the whole publicity surrounding this speech has been geared towards making the other thing happen.
Is this tour outside?
What's that?
Well, where's the brother coming in at?
I mean, there's going to be a bus arriving with lots of children. shortly at the front of the building.
Does anyone bring their flamethrower?
So does the tour go outside at any point?
I
hate
hobos.
No, but you assume that whenever the
children arrive, they're gonna go outside to meet them.
Yeah.
Will our lady go outside to meet them?
Mizuhashi?
Yeah.
Oh, I doubt it. I mean, the people who are gonna go outside are literally there to go see their younger siblings. The actual tour doesn't take place until later today.
How can we bait her outside?
She's gotta leave us.
Maybe we could just fill her in. Tell her we have to leave now, under the cover of this crowd. Your life's in extreme danger.
Alright, I think you should whisper that to her. I'm gonna run over to the chancellor like as quick as possible and like whisper in her ear. It's like, I think this this tour is clearly a cover up. We gotta get her out of here now. And she's like, I advise you keep your head low and beef up your own security.
Asumi just like kind of nods and heads up with her own group of bodyguards and the vice chancellor.
Yeah.
I say
what I say to Mrs. Mizahihuha.
Will she be shepherded out by me and Card?
I was just gonna lead her out myself.
Go both with her if you want. She's totally gonna agree with your consideration.
Tell her, and then like have me and Card form like a human protective shield, like you know Secret Service does when.
Yeah.
And then.
So Card's like 3 feet tall.
Demon's gonna see the signal, I guess, which is us filing out of the building, and take the shot.
All right. Is that actually happening, though?
I assume the death cultists, you know, if anyone was actually paying attention to where he was, he's right there, and everyone can see him.
Some random poor sap.
Okay, so
actually, is there random people milling around outside?
Yeah, have him shoot one of the children.
School children. There's
shoot the children. Shoot the children.
Driver. There's lots
of death cultists. Shoot the teacher. Hold on.
Is there anybody like standing next to you guys? Just like some random unimportant staff member.
Maybe children.
I'm assuming the lady we're gonna try to pretend to assassinate has a staff member following her.
Well, you killed her secretary. I mean.
She must have, like, a bodyguard or something, too.
Sure, she has a bodyguard, yeah.
Alright, have the death cultist take out the bodyguard.
And then I'm gonna take my shot immediately afterwards.
And then, like, once, like, the death cultist takes the shot, me and Card are gonna, like, throw our bodies on top of her.
So make sure to pull her out of the way as fast as possible.
So, the death cultist, suddenly there's a loud gunfire sound as the extremely unsilenced Imperial sniper rifle bursts into the atmosphere and strikes the security bodyguard guy next to Mizuhashi straight in the dome, exploding his whole head.
It's a good shot.
Blood and bone fragments splatter across Mizuhashi as well as you guys.
And the faces of horrified children.
They're screaming. You can see Miyuki and Kanasumi both running towards the bus to get their siblings. There are people panicking and running. There's some of the press are directing their cameras, trying to figure out where the shot came from.
Alright, well, I'm gonna pull, I don't have a gun, shit.
Vox someone.
And put her bodies around her and like grab her and like run off with her, and Demon take the shot.
Okay.
This is 25.
Yeah, so Demon, you have lined up the shot way before this has even happened, and you knew exactly where to hit and had confirmed it would and everything before the event. And the mag rifle just pretty much silently lets forth a chunk of metal at extreme velocity, penetrating the brain of the death cultist member and kind of just shattering it. And he just kind of is completely motionless because he was already prone and completely relaxed. So he's
rest
dead.
In peace.
I'm gonna like
literally the only person who's mattered who has died.
Get the hell out of there.
I'll be fine.
And like, let's get her around a corner until like, where should we take her? I feel like
I don't.
Card, you need to rerun off with her.
Sure, I'll take her to the fucking Imperial Palace. Assuming it's right around the corner.
It's not. It's several. It's a couple of
assuming
blocks.
I have some
more to communicate
with. Have
Clark just,
like,
pull her in a door to the Senate building.
Telling that that we're clear. This is beautiful.
So you're doing what exactly? I'm sorry?
What do you want to do with her card?
Well, Asami Imai already knows that the building itself is protected. The congressional building we were just in.
Well, she's gone. Asami Imai, she left out the back.
Yeah, but it would make sense that we, go back in for, so. That wouldn't be weird, at least to her. So, yeah, okay. I'll tell her,
follow me.
Yeah.
And at this point, I'm going to call the Chancellor immediately, and I'll be like, we took out the target. There was only one casualty. It was the bodyguard.
She's like, okay, that's good. Just make sure nothing else happens. This is already fucked enough. And she hangs up. You can hear she's, like, moving, being shepherded somewhere.
Nice.
So, yeah, Demon, you're kind of... Are you just staying on the building? Or are you coming down?
It's fucking, like, packing up and starting to move out of the building. Fancy suit,
and,
everything.
I want to flash some papers, and I want to get to the top of the building where the death cultist is, yeah.
That's the executive building across the street, so that's where you're going?
Yeah, but before I go over there, I want to call the proper, like, authorities. Like, I'm assuming there's some guards running around.
Okay.
And I want them to escort me up to the roof so they know I'm not tampering with anything.
Okay, sure.
And once they get up there, they see I'm not tampering. I'm gonna tell them to watch the horizon.
Well, okay, so you're heading up the building. Card, you are in the.
I'm consoling her, and like we go in. I guess we'll go into like a single person room, or like maybe her office.
Okay, sure. You can go to her office. Yeah. That
and
makes
we'll.
Sense.
I'll tell her everything's totally all right, Mrs. Nipnong. We have the situation under control.
Okay, so the security forces that are with you, Matt, they kind of report to you and say, well, sir, the security system at the congressional building seems to have gone offline. Do you know anything about that?
No, deal with the threat immediately.
Okay,
Send like half of them packing.
Okay, the children and the senators have, been stored, like, they're just getting away from the area, basically, into their own
imagine
private cars and security around.
Peeled out.
The bus is fucking gone, yes. and really, it's just the press on the lawn of the building, and,
I should have taken some shots at them.
Do it!
I'm already packed up.
Yeah. Basically, no, I mean, you should not actually shoot them.
As you get to the top of the building, Matt, you see the corpse of the sniper and his weapon, and you look out over the chaos, and there's people still kind of running around. The news is like people, lots of different newscasters are just like shouting about the horror at the congressional building, and then suddenly, two massive explosions rip through the congressional building. One of them very clearly in the direction of the house. Blue flame rockets out of windows, destroying glass. A massive fire erupts.
Surf.
The other one.
Surf.
Explodes it's not nearly as large of an explosion, but it's orange flame, and it's coming out of the area where the security booth was at the building. Now there's even more panic. The roof of the house has been collapsed by this, and if there was any level of panic before, it's erupted much higher now.
I guess am I alive?
That is where the session will end. For
no! Wait, I gotta do one thing before the session ends.
What is it? What you want to do?
I want to have one of the guards take pictures of the body and the cell phone on the ground next to him and the micro bead. I'm gonna do the same, and I'm gonna send them to the Chancellor, just so that's all documented.
Okay.
So did I die?
No, you were in the Senate area. There was no bomb there.
Oh, okay.
I'm
that those bombs were meant for the children.